The Chicago Blackhawks and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Two original six teams who are following hockey's house rule. Don't get mad, get even. Both teams roar early.
Mark's long shot! Roenick kept at it. Roenick put it ahead. Amonteh scores! Hot night tonight for Amonteh.
They've lasted on the best saves.
Here comes Brutu.
They've saved the best for last.
Clark is on it, forechecking with Gilmore behind the net, pushed it out front. It got to the line, and Gil shot it! Wendell Clark is in front of the net.
Played it in off his stick. Knocked that one over the net, in front of the net, it's centered, from the score! Jeremy Roenick has won the game for Chicago.
To each his home. And so we're square. Tonight it's game five back in Toronto. Be there and be square. How big is game five? If you watched Hockey Night in Canada last night and the Habs and the Bruins and saw the urgency in their approach, well, you know, tonight it's game five as the scene shifts to Maple Leaf Gardens, Toronto for the Hawks and the Leafs. Good evening and welcome to Molson Hockey Night in Canada in the Stanley Cup playoffs. I'm Ron McLean. A lot of players could be named MVP in this series, but surely a case has to be made for Doug Gilmore and Jeremy Roenick. We spoke to the star centers moments ago to get their to-do lists for tonight's big game.
Well, the biggest thing is we can't change too much. We've made some mental mistakes that cost us the game. And we got to go out, we got to play hard, we got to initiate, not retaliate. And our main focus is to make sure that when Jeremy Roenick lines on the ice, Suter and Shelley also be hit those guys and get a lot of pressure on Dolphin.
Well, we really have been very patient as far as being in this building. It's been very hard to play against some of the guys that Pat Burns has put out against us. But I think if we just play our style of game and create as much speed as possible, I have tremendous fast wingers with Joe Murphy and Tony Amonteh, and if we can get some speed going and move the puck as well as possible with Shelley and Suits moving it up to us, I think we can generate a lot of offense. So we just have to make sure that we stay patient and stay composed. I mean, they're going to try to throw a lot of bodies at us and make sure that they take us off our game. But if we stick to our guns and go with speed and get to the net, I think we can do some damage.
The Leafs and the Hawks are on the ice. The importance of Game 5, well, since 1987 in the new format, there have been 39 series where the teams were split after the first four games. The team winning Game 5 has prevailed in the series 35 of 39 times. And what's more, if it's the visitor that wins that fifth game, they've gone on to win the series 16 of 17 times. Only the Penguins beating New Jersey in 91 is an exception. So if Chicago wins, the heat is really on the Maple Leafs. In the broadcast booth tonight, our 25-year colleague Barb Cole will provide the play-by-play. There he was this morning with Richie Sutter, and Harry Neal's with me. Let's begin with the pressure being on Toronto. Do you believe that, Harry?
No, I don't. It's the best two out of three. The Leafs have two of the three home games. What's the degree of panic I sense in Toronto?
What do they have to do, Toronto?
Well, I think they first have to neutralize Chelios and Suter. These two guys have been monumental. When the Leafs are without the puck in their own zone, they have to make sure that these guys can't slap it with a big step off the blue line, can't pinch without any regard, and can't go to the slot by themselves for that dangerous 35-footer. Get your wingers out on them to start with and forget about them.
Well, Suter and Chelios, 35 minutes a game, third game in four nights. What about the Leafs? Or the Hawks, I should say.
The Hawks have to get some goals from people other than the Roenick line. Not one forward other than the Roenick group has scored a goal in four games. Where is Brent Sutter? Where is Isobart? Where is Duke Graham? Suter needs these three guys to chip some goals in.
Boy, it's loud in here. The loudest it's been in the playoffs thus far at Maple Leaf Gardens, just like Chicago. What a series, regular season and playoffs between these two. Here are the starting lineups with Paul Morris.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Game 5 of the Western Conference quarterfinals. Tonight's starting lineup for the Chicago Blackhawks. On defense, number 20, Gary Suter. On defense, number 7, Chris Chelios. Left wing, number 10, Tony Amonte. And right wing, number 17, Joe Murphy. And center, number 27, Jeremy Roenick. Starting in goal, number 30, Ed Belfour.
So far,
It's been a home series. Leafs, games one and two, one of them in overtime. Chicago, 3-4, with an overtime win on Sunday. Someone takes charge tonight. Good evening, everybody. Bob Cole in the booth with Harry Neal. And the two teams, Chicago and Toronto, ready to go at it in game five here at Maple Leaf Garden. Ed Belfour in goal for Chicago sparked the Blackhawks in game four, making 34 saves. The heat has turned up a notch for the goalies tonight. Felix Potvin, his second playoff year, and already he's been through the ringer more than his share, and yet another pressure-packed game tonight. Don Kuharski is the referee. Ron Finn and Brad Lazarowicz will work the lines. Chelios, Suter, Murphy, Roenick, and Amonte starting for Chicago. McCown and Lefebvre for the Leafs. Berg, Zazzle, Osborne, the forward line. Jamie McCown is being watched by Jeremy Roenick. Boy, it's so important for these two teams to get the jump. Which one will it be? Shot in by Berg. Here's Zazzle. Goes and Suter was waiting for that. Murphy just dumped it out over the line and the Leafs ram it back in. Suter back. His pass to Roenick. Zezel was bumped hard inside the blue line. McCown will wait a second and now lift it back in. The Leafs are changing right off the bat. Chelios coming out. Zezel went in there and nailed Suter. Roenick's backhander. Just to the right of the net, and Potvin wisely put his glove on it because Kirk Ream was coming in very close.
Well, we knew the Leafs were going to come out hitting. The first period of all these games has been the toughest. Chicago Blackhawks put Dirk in for Wilkinson, and on the forward line they put Dave Christian in for Poulin. I think a move to get two seasoned veterans in for two relatively inexperienced NHLers in this, the critical game five.
Now this line has Izabart, Brent Sutter, and Graeme left to right. The Leafs have Gartner at center ice again. No, Gilmore comes on now. He'll go in to take the faceoff. There's Gartner. He'll play the wing, and Clark is on the other side. So Pat Burns will move him around quite likely tonight. Gartner met right away with a light bump from Carney. The Blackhawks shoot it in, and Dave Ellis, the defenseman back there with Todd Gill. Ellis getting over a separated shoulder, but he appears to be quick. Shoots the puck down the ice. Carney back. Can he touch it? He did not, but the other Blackhawk player, Izabart, did, and that's icing called against Toronto.
Well, Pat Burns is going to play Gilmore a lot tonight on two different lines. Pat has made one change in his lineup. The six defensemen are the same. I think you'll see Lefebvre and McCown play a lot against Roenick. And he's inserted McCrae for John Cullen. A little size, a little physicalness here in Maple Leaf Gardens. Doug Gilmore has a four-game playoff point streak. This year, two goals, six assists for 8 points, 24 points in 14 playoff games against Chicago. What a great matchup. Gilmore, the best center on the Leafs. Roenick, a similar spot for the Hawks.
Brent Sutter now back on for Chicago for the draw against Eastwood. Ron Finn, the linesman, dropping it in. The Leafs kept the puck on that faceoff. Gill shot it to the corner. McCrae with his first turn of this game. He's number 40 for Toronto. Gill will go over there to pick it up in the corner. Can't move it out, though. The Blackhawks get it in front of Graeme. McCrae didn't see the puck and came up from behind. And he was watching Suter. Obviously, that's his chore when he's out there. To get to the defenseman at the blue line. From center ice, Ellis will just shoot it in. Suter missed it. Larutu takes over. Gets the puck out. Green is knocked down at center ice. And Dave Ellis will bring it back in for Toronto. Ellis and McCrae gets a shot. Big rebound off that save by Belfour. Eastwood fighting for it on the boards. He was hit hard by Green. The two players go to the ice. Two tipped it near the blue line. It's down the ice. Vanderbilt went in there. They're really working over Gary Suter early in the hockey game. Now, Don Sutter. He'll let him go, or he'll really clamp down. And so far, the sign is, go to it, boys.
I think you'll let him hit all night. What he will call are retaliation penalties and fouls from behind. Two penalties that Koharski likes to call. This is McRae's third lifetime playoff game. He wrapped a few guys in games one and game two, and I think Burns liked that and didn't get enough of it in Chicago. Now, Chicago has set six skaters on the ice. They can't do that and then make a change. They got to get down to five skaters, then up goes Koharski's hand, and Burns can then make a change. Daryl Sutter's assignment tonight, and maybe the biggest one for him, keep Burns from getting all the matchups he wants, especially against the Roanoke line, and still get Roanoke's group 25 to 30 minutes of play.
Another switch for Gilmore now. He has Andrzejczyk and Borzewski on the wings. A count shot. A high one got through a crowd and missed. High to the far side. Gilmore will try to keep it in. But Amonte got it back out over the line and slammed in there by Andrzejczyk. Greg Smith, number three for Chicago. Roenick picks it up, looking for a bit of room, and finds it for himself. The relay back to him, got over his stick, and then Murphy missed it. McCown coming back in, but he gave it away to Suter. Coming up with Roenick, Suter's shot, a weak one, and that was blocked by Lafay. The steady defenseman for Toronto lifted one near the blue line, not out. Borzewski is coming back to take over, and he gives it to Andrzejczyk, who turns with Gilmore, and the pass intended for Borzewski was a little bit too far. Monty backs up near his own line, throws it back, and now Chelios hitting center ice. Long shot. Putman hasn't had a stop so far. There's his first. Belfour's had one also. From center, shot back in. Putman out of the net to stop for McCown. Chance chasing him. McCown just had to get it out. Here's a right wing pass to Schatz. He'll get a shot away, but it's deflected high over the glass and into the crowd up behind Felix Potvin. Harry, you get a feeling they're starting with a little bit of cautious work so far anyway.
Well, Pat Burns was the first to admit mistakes cost him both games three and four. It isn't making mistakes that's critical. It's correcting them quickly and getting on with the principal task. That's his assignment for tonight. These kind of passes are nice when they're completed, but they put your teammates in an awful spot when they're intercepted. And you have to be careful doing it. There was no doubt about the fact that Zezel was in the clear, but you got to get him the puck.
Nobody so far in the game, we are nearing the 4-minute mark, has broken to the net. With the puck, here's Weinrich. He'll get a shot right on. Bounce down to Mironov. Leafs do not get it out. Lifted in by Chance. Christian on the ice for his first turn. He's wearing number 25 for Chicago. Leafs can't get it out. Chance shot one at the net. Eastwood blocked and stopped by Christian. The pass comes back in front, and now three Leafs will pick it up and skate away. Pearson lifts one in, wide of the goal, and Belfour just shot it off the glass. All the way down the ice, and Popeye is going to play it. 4:20 gone in the first. No score. Just 2-1 in shots so far. Chicago with the two. Everything has been long range so far. This is Suter with Chelios, his defense partner. Suter goes to Rich Sutter. He's in with a shot. That's knocked down in front by Ruutu, but he couldn't control it. And he was checked very quickly. Cunningworth falling to the ice. Gill takes it back to the net for Toronto. Gill having a tough time deciding which way to come out. Fake one way, got the other. Zezel lost it. And Berg got back to pick it up and get it down there for Osborne. Osborne rubbed off along the boards by Suter. Zezel, hard hit in there for the Leafs. Osborne back of the net. Trying to get a pass over in front of the goal, but he's covered. Brent Sutter has him tied up. Berg moved in with Zezel, with Osborne, and the pass back to Gill didn't work. Brent Sutter skates back out for Chicago. In goes Green. He couldn't get by Ellen. And Green turned Ellen around. Finally, Ellen picked it up and gave it to Gill. Quick pass. boards for Osborne. Big giveaway, that pass along the blue line, but fortunately for Osborne and the Leafs, Green couldn't control it. Here's Roenick winding up as the Leafs are changing. He gets a nice bit of space to get going. Grabbed from behind by Gertner, and that stopped that rush. Now Clark, he's moving up over the line. Here's Gilmeier, it is! Can't get the shot by Belfour, though. The best scoring chance of the hockey game thus far. They're pushing and shoving in front of the Chicago net. Dirt is on the ice all over Gilmore. Kowarski let him go at it. Roenick is moving out. Roenick shot, blocked by Putman. And now it's starting to warm up a bit here in Game 5 at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is a big game.
Some get it in a season. Some in a career. Some can only dream of getting $1 million, and you could win a chance to shoot for it. Scratch the neck label or call for details on entry with that purchase.
Are you sure they said center ice?
The Molson Canadian Stanley Cup Contest.
I think they said the condo.
Take
money.
Your best shot.
Hockey Night in Canada on CBC is brought to you by Molson Canadian. Take your best shot in the Molson Canadian Score a Million Stanley Cup Contest. By Ford of Canada, where quality is job one. And by Pepsi. Be young, have fun, drink Pepsi.
Appreciably. Big crowd again on hand at Maple Leaf Gardens. Chicago and Toronto in another pivotal game in the series. The series tied at 2 apiece. Game 6 back at the Chicago Stadium. And a necessary 7 here at Maple Leaf Gardens. 6 minutes, 27 seconds into the opening period. Here in Game 5. Roenick, Murphy, and Amonte on the ice again for Chicago. Zassel for the Leafs, won the draw, got it down the ice. Osborne and Bird obviously have a chore checking the Chicago big line. Zassel gets him a good run in the shot. Bird without the helmet was set up by Zassel, and Zassel did some mighty fine work along the boards against two Blackhawks to get that pass out of Belfour stopping.
Well, I've always said, when you give the Zassel line a specific assignment, their game improves by about 25%. Tonight, they've got the Jeremy Roenick line and Chelios and Suter in their bomb sights. And some good hard forechecking ended up causing a good Leaf chance here, and Belfour makes the stop on Bill Byrne. There's no doubt about it. Pat Burns wants these five guys against the Chelios, Suter, Roenick combination, and then he'll come back with Gilmore. Means that Roenick will not get a chance to play against one of the two Gilmore lines. This time Clark and Gartner, sometimes Warshevsky.
Face off to the left of Ed Belfour. Brent Sutter whipped the pass right across in front of his own net. Chelios can't get out on the first try. Clark is there bumping with Green. Gartner and Gilmore, the other forwards on there for Toronto. And here's Brent Sutter moving up with a long shot, nowhere near the net. But it came off the boards out in front of the crease. And Pompak, again looking at Dirk Graham, was going for the net all the time. He smothered it.
Well, Dirk Graham playing on this line with Sutter most of the time. They fool around with another winger. A great seasoned veteran. And as I said in the opening, you need a goal from this guy. They need a goal from Brent Sutter. These guys have been around. They know all about what the playoffs are. They have to chip in offensively. We know they're going to do a good job defensively. We know they're not going to be outworked. And we know they're going to throw as many checks as they take. But this guy's brother, Daryl Sutter, the coach, needs a little offense from this group.
Brent Sutter again, Eisenbart to his left, Graham to his right, Chelios and Suter at the blue line. Gill and Ellett, the Leafs defenseman. There is Borshevsky. Gilmore, and here's Andrzejczyk. Andrzejczyk shot it in for Gilmore. He might get there. And he missed it trying to get in. And the puck is out into the center ice area. Gilmore backs up. Pass through center ice. Borshevsky to Andrzejczyk. He didn't get too far with it. Brett Sutter got away from Gilmore. It's shot in. Gilmore has to get back onside, however, allowing Chelios plenty of time to go back. Big number seven for Chicago out to Green. Pulling away from Andrzejczyk. Dirk Green's long drive skipped off a leg and went wide of the net. Chicago changing. That is Rutsu in front of the net now for checking. Andrzejczyk whacked it out to center ice. Borshevsky was stood up in his tracks at center by Dirk. Andrzejczyk cut away from Rutsu. Played it in for Borshevsky along the boards. And the little winger gets into the corner and then lost it. Gilmore went in there with a hard hit on Smith. Smith gets the pass across ice to Rich Sutter. Dancing in there from the left side. And right into the puck bag, going through the crease. And then he got beat by Gilmore. And there will be a penalty. Gilmore didn't like the way Rich Sutter went through the crease and bumped the goaltender. And Koharski was looking back just in case. And there was Gilmore, and he gave it to Rich Sutter.
Those are the kind of penalties that Doug Gilmore said they can't take. They want to initiate, not retaliate. I know what he was doing. He was sticking up for his goalie. And maybe there should have been a penalty on Rich Sutter, but there wasn't. And now the Leafs have to kill off the power play.
Well, it's the first penalty of this game, and it comes at 8:26. It'll be a roughing call against Doug Gilmore. And he's not happy about things. Saw Rich Sutter there, and he was fair game, he thought. Didn't like the way he went through the crease and bumped Putman and nailed him. The power play in the series. Chicago, a little weak in that department. But let's see what happens now. They have Roney, Murphy, Amonte, Chelios, and Suter. Chelios will wait, trying to draw Leaf. He didn't get any work from McCown. He just kept backing up. So he had to shoot it back to the net. There it is, back to the other side. And Suter lost it. Bird from center. Long shot for Balfour on the blocker. Suter and Chelios. Zezel and Berg are the forwards for Toronto. Lefebvre and McCown, the defenseman, that shot in. It comes out. Putman didn't see it. But fortunately for Putman, the Leafs, it took a crazy hop off the boards. Putman was looking the other way, where the puck should have gone. Nearly hit him on the skates. But the Leafs get away with that one. 1:05 left in the penalty. Osborne intercepting. Takes the puck up to the Chicago line and lost it. A minute left. Gilmore, the penalized player in the box. The first power play of the hockey game. No score. Nearing the halfway mark of the first period. Isobard is coming up. He shoots it in. There goes Rutsu to pick it up off the boards, but Vanderbilt was waiting for it. Shot it back in the net. Ellett gets a chance to clear it, and he does. Here's Balfour, saving a few seconds. The Leafs were changing. Weinrich up to Rutsu. And it goes to Christian, going in a goal. He centered it out of Lefebvre. Shoots it away. 24 seconds left in the penalty to Gilmore. The Leafs are hanging on so far. Keeping Chicago outside. Dirk Green giving a bump. Zezel goes over on the boards. Working hard with his skates, trying to move it out. Chicago winning that little battle. Played in at the side of the net. The shot right through the crease, and here's Gilmore. Coming on the ice, they kill the penalty. Gilmore goes right after the Chicago player, Cuddyworth, and nailed him. What a spirited hockey player Dougie Gilmore is. Number 93. First penalty of the game, out of the box, and Wendell, who's got the puck. And he nailed Cuddyworth. There's Cuddyworth, a little upset. And you can understand that. 9:17 remaining in the first.
New Ford Windstar, I'd say it's the evolution of the minivan. I've never heard of another minivan that has all of these safety features standard.
The dual airbags.
Yeah. Four-wheel anti-lock brakes.
Those things that...
This reinforced side beams are...
They make me feel really comfortable driving my children in a car where I know they're safe. I like the fact that there's a child-proof safety lock on the sliding door, the 24-hour roadside assistance. I like to know I can call and get help right away. The Ford Windstar, that's great. Safety is so important to me. It has to be one of the most important things when you're a mom.
If you only knew what the future had in store. You'd never pick any carpet but the ones made to take years of use without showing their age. DuPont approved Stainmaster carpets.
Well, could have been twins.
Stainmaster. Why trust the future to anything?
Well, goalies can't trust the glass in any rink, although this is one of the more trustworthy rinks. Buffalo, Boston, St. Louis, goaltenders are petrified when they come out. You're right, Bob. Puckman was lucky there was no red shirt in the area. Doug Gilmore, you could spell his name H-A-R-T. Could win that trophy some year, boy. He's monstrous to the Leafs.
Toronto wins the draw. The shot, though, by Rouse doesn't get through. Rouse takes it near center. And Eastwood, he shoots it in. Manderville with Pearson and Eastwood for Toronto. Pearson bumping Dirk Crane. Puck over the glass into the crowd. Quinn Sutter, a lot of ice time so far in this first period. I think now he might be going off.
Well, this is three games in four nights, and it'll be a bruising game like the first two were. You have to wonder whether the 30-plus minute men are going to start to show some signs of fatigue. And both teams have got them. We've talked about Chelios and Suter play a lot. So does Gilmore, who plays well over 30 minutes. Roenick, that line does. Chelios, Suter, 30 to 38 minutes apiece in the first four games. Pretty close series, five skaters against five. The Leafs have an edge in power play with seven goals against four.
Zezelberg and Osborne. So that means the Roenick line is on for Chicago, right? Right. Murphy and Amati on the wings. Chelios is bumped immediately by Osborne. Here comes Berg to help out. The Leafs forechecking now with the body. Zezel shoots it into the corner boards. Roenick is bumped by Osborne. Down! Berg with another chance on the short side. Belfour stopped a second pass out. Chicago finding this checking line of the Leafs. A little tough in the early going. Roenick is upended near center. Another Leaf penalty coming up, but Roenick was shaken up on that hit near center ice. I think he's hurt. There'll be a Leaf penalty. And Roenick was shaken up.
Osborne cross-checked him right in the face. A two-minute penalty. Roenick went down, quickly checked itself. The Leafs kill another one off. Not the kind of penalty you can take. I mean, I know they want to hit Roenick. Well, let's have a look at it right here.
Got the stick up, all right. 11:42 is the time.
The Leafs penalty killing here at Maple Leaf Gardens. They've allowed only one goal in 10 Chicago power plays. Not quite as successful in Chicago, but that's a brilliant 90% success rate.
Only two penalties in the game so far, both against Toronto. The first one to Gilmore was killed off without any damage. There's no score in this first period, 8:18 remaining. Roenick is okay, he remains on. Murphy and Amati on the wings. Chelios and Suter logging up the time early again tonight. Zezel and Berg. Lefebvre and McCown. Suter likely will give it to Chelios or maybe the other side. And yes, the shot. Luck by Puck. Roenick was open on that side, even though Chelios was in a better spot, straight for the net. And Roenick had the angle. So did Puttman.
Well, Zezel facing off against Roenick in the penalty killing. Watch what Peter Zezel does here. He loses the draw, but he trips Roenick. And then Roenick makes a smart play. And this is why he ended up with a good chance. Zezel, the penalty-killing forward, who's supposed to take the deep man in the Toronto zone, fell down and couldn't get out in time, and Ronick let a 40-footer go with some mustard on it.
Gilmore and Manderville are on there now. McCown and LePave remain on. It's McCown, the veteran, picked it up. Palmy shot it through a hole down the ice. And penalties behind the play. Maybe against Chicago. Murphy and Manderville were bumping back there. And Murphy for sure is getting one. And I think that will be it. First Chicago penalty. So they're even now, five aside.
Well, this is the trouble Chicago had in game one, if you recall. They took away a lot of their power play. And you can see the pileup at the half one draw. Then Murphy and Eastwood fall together. And Murphy's got a hold of Eastwood's stick. And the power play lasted 14 seconds. Joe Murphy's making a bit of a habit out of neutralizing hot power plays in this series. I'm sure Daryl Sutter doesn't appreciate that. His team's power play in this rink has cost him as much as anything, two wins.
Holding the stick against Murphy, 11:56. So they're five aside now, and the Leafs will have a 14-second power play for their first. That's short enough. 5-4 of the shots. Chicago out front of that department. No score in this first period. Series tied at two apiece. Two wins here for Toronto. Two wins there for Chicago. Won a game in overtime. Leafs the second. The Blackhawks the fourth. Ellick couldn't control that one. Tried to glove it. Gardner having a tough time controlling this. Gets to center. And a little bit of room. And a little bit of speed. Circles the net. Gardner finally hit back there. And he lost it. Chelios decided to play the body. And he did that. Suter carries up over the Leaf line. Gary Suter getting in close. And it's steered away by Gardner. Lots of room now for him as he's down there against Graham. He swings around in easily. In front he goes. Couldn't get the backhander along the ice by Belfour. Was upended as he crashed into the goaltender. 1 minute left to the Leaf penalty. Minute 14 now in the Chicago penalty. Blackhawks come in. Ronick fades back. Put on the brakes. Move back. Centered it. And we'll get to the line. And there goes Gilmore. He's down across the Chicago line. Dropping it back to Ellett. He circles. Gets in front. The shot deflected. And Belfour will jump out of the net and cover up. And he, no doubt, will have a few things to say to Gilmore, who skated by rather closely.
Gilmore sometimes is careless on the rush, and in this one is a good example. He cuts across and nearly gets hit. Gardner, realizing the one-on-one was against Dirk Graham, who was filling in for his defenseman, and Dirk, like most forwards, can't turn to their outside, and Gardner beat him, but he couldn't finesse the puck by Belfour. And he gives Chelios a facial massage here from behind and was kind of lucky he didn't take a penalty. Boharski watched it. Gardner. They need Gardner to score. Gardner and Clark. Gardner's had lots of chances. Can't put it in, and there was another one.
39 seconds left on the Osborne penalty, 53, and the Chicago penalty. No score, first period, 6:50 left. Weinrich starting from the Chicago zone. Dropped the pass back up to Carney now at center, and he shoots it in. Puffback. Stop that. Route 2 is feeding in. Gilmore finds a little bit of room. That's all he needed, obviously, but now he almost loses it. And Route 2 tries to center it. Route 2 still looking to move it out front. He and Ronick battle for it. Ronick gets the shot. He nearly stuffed it in. And Poffman made the save. Chicago causing a few problems for the Leafs. In back of that net.
Well, Ronick tripped Gilmore. Gilmore was skating away from behind the net. That gave Jeremy a chance to cut out in front and nearly score on the wraparound. It's defensive zone coverage here. Route 2 McCowan, Gilmore Ronick. And Gilmore is getting out of the way here and gets tripped. Ronick grabs it, comes around, and Futban has to be sharp to keep it out.
Still no score. That, though, was a close call. The crowd wanted a penalty called, and Jeremy Roenick, what a workhorse. What was it Daryl Sutherland was saying the other day when somebody asked him, why don't you use him more often? How can you? He works so much, so hard every time he's out there. You can't work him to death.
You'd love to coach him, though, boy. You love to coach those kind of players. Roenick, Gilmore, they give you more than they've got more often than not.
Gilmore is on again, of course, and he won the draw, slipped it back into the corner to the right of the Leaf net. Osborne is out of the penalty box. The Leafs have a very short power play now, and they're very deep in their own zone. Only 5 seconds left in the Chicago penalty, and the Leafs are unable to get it out. Gilmore moves in at the center. Chicago penalty is over. Gilmore coming in there, spinning back to the line. The long shot! Hit the post on the left side. Chicago getting the puck in the center ice zone. Murphy stopped. Chance shot it over the Leaf line. And Rouse is back to the net for the Blackhawks. Were changing. Rouse turning the other way and got it up as far as center. Dirk brings it back in. Gets the shot. That'll go into the crowd. Easily deflected by Bob Rouse, and it went over the glass and behind Potvin again with 5:29 left in the first period.
Introducing the Quantum Random Orbit Sander. It's tough enough to tackle any project from start to finish. Plus, it's backed by a 3-year warranty. The new Quantum line, only from Black & Decker.
So you're going to be able to manage all this?
Oh, sure. Oh, gee, I've got to go.
What's up?
Oh, Casablanca's on TV tonight. It's my all-time favorite.
Oh, that's a great movie. Play it again, Vic.
Oh, dear.
You know, like Lothario, play it again. 2 chances for a buck.
Right, Gordon. Oh, look, here's my sheet. But I've got to go, so I'll get the ticket from you later.
Here's looking at you, kid. You know, this could be the start of a beautiful...
Made a little work.
Play Lothario. Ontario's winning tradition.
It has begun. There's a new Ontario Hydro committed to ensuring a promising, energy-efficient future for us and for those who come after. The new Ontario Hydro.
Roderick Dirk stepping in for Wilkinson. He missed. You can see the Shiners got into a fight with Todd Gill in game one. Woke up and couldn't see out of his eye. Missed game two, missed game three and four. Back in here in game five.
He's out there now with Greg Smith. Brett Sutter again. Chicago Blackhawks. Graham and Isobar at the wingers. Eastwood is on for Toronto. Waved out, and Manderville will take the draw. Pearson is the other forward. The Leafs get it ahead for Pearson. He got as far as center, and then dropped it in for Manderville, hitting the net. Side of the post. Another centering pass. Gill shot. Steered away by Belfour. The Leafs press a bit here. Stopped by Ellen at the blue line. They keep it in. Pearson. Manderville. Again, he hit the side of the net. Centered again to Pearson. Manderville working hard back, and the goal is pinned there by Smith. But he gets loose somehow. Manderville dropped it over back of the net again. Eastwood tries to center it. The Blackhawks will come out as Pearson was upended. Belfour will cover up on that play. Chicago gets a penalty here. And the Leafs will go on the power play.
They're back in the City of Champions, Toronto's best road team ever. Introducing our winning 94 lineup, Aerostar, Villager, and rookie sensation, 1995 Windstar. Built for Torontonians in their own backyard, Windstar has 7-passenger seating, dual airbags, 4-wheel ABS, and lots more. Now, till May 2nd, Windstar, Villager, and Aerostar give you the chance to win one of 34 nights in a skybox. No purchase required. See your Toronto Ford or Mercury minivan center or write for an entry form.
Cheese, please.
Mm-hmm.
nice to have a taste for life.
Canadian cheese, please.
.437 left in the opening period, and the faceoff to the right of Ed Belfour. Gardner, Gilmore, Clark, Ellett, and Mironov. On the faceoff, Ellett, shot, blocked by Belfour, and they'll do it again. It was right.
Well, Bob, the Leafs have scored 7 of their 13 goals in this series on the power play. It was functioning well. Here's the penalty to Dirk Graham. He tripped him. He tripped Manderville.
Here's Ellett from the faceoff. Elects not to shoot it at the net. Crowd trying to rifle the goaltender. And Belfour in the Leafs power play as Clark playing it back to Ellett again. Deflected in front. Gardner has dumped Mironov, tipped it in. Shot out. Ellett rifles it back into the Chicago zone. Here's Gilmore for Mironov to Ellett. He'll get a weak shot. Deflected by Gardner and just wide. Now Mironov drives wide. That was blocked by Roenick. Took the stick out of his hands. Mironov has to come back. 1:15 left in the Chicago penalty. No score, first period. Mironov having a tough time pulling away. Gets by Murphy, then lost it to Murphy, and the Blackhawks shoot it down the ice. 1:05 left in the penalty. Ellett back. Gilmore circles to his left. Clark goes to the right side. It is Ellett who'll bring it out. Skates it out to Borshevsky over the line and dumped it to the far corner. Rick Sutter ripped it on the boards, but Gil stopped that, kicking it in the midsection. Rick Sutter again. Clark took it from him. Here comes one. That was blocked, and he has to hustle back out to stop Rick Sutter. 35 seconds left in the power play, and the Leafs get it in again. Gil was bumped by Kearney as he went after it. Borshevsky didn't see it. Now Anderson lovely passed it back. The Leafs were changing, and McCown couldn't get there in time. Weinrich shot. 12 seconds left of the penalty. No score. Leafs one more rush. It goes down the right side for Borshevsky with Gilmore. Borshevsky passes back to Gil. Into Gilmore. Right in. Rebound. And Andrew Chuck was covered in front of the net. Gilmore is still tied up there in the pre-serve. The penalty is over. Gilmore gets loose. Gilmore trying to come out front with it. Here he is. Up front. Remaining in the first period, we are scoreless.
Pepsi Max.
It's new. All the taste of regular cola and a third the calories.
Yeah, sure.
Tastes good, that's all I know.
Gull la beau.
Can't you just enjoy it without the analysis, Sigmund?
What do you think stops some crazy bigwig at Pepsi from just printing up a bunch of false labels?
Jail.
Oh, brother, you are so naive.
New Pepsi Max.
Could you get him a fork?
All the taste, one-third the calories.
Well, Gilmore had a great chance to score as he walked out of the corner taking a nice pass here and couldn't put it in. He's hit hard that time. But the next time, Cunningworth leveled him.
Clark set it up. Mironov shot. Tipped by Andrechuk and over the net. Andrechuk for Gilmore. Hopped over his stick. Blackhawks trying to get it out. This is another power play for Toronto. Gray misses it at center, and Gilmore circles again. Up through center. White wing pass, here's Clark! And he missed the top corner. Clark back of the net. Gilmore was in front. Ellett trying to keep it in, but Brent Sutter shoots the puck to center ice. 1:25 left in the penalty. No score. The 40 left in the period. Gallup moving up again. Center ice. High one to the glass to the left of Ed Belfour. Chicago back. Gary Suter. And he found a way to get it out and down the ice. And Murphy chases Mironov. He made a couple of good fakes and got away from him. Another one. And he comes to center. Down goes Clark. He has some speed up on this rush. Clark coming in around the net. Centered it. Belfour got a spin on it. And the Blackhawks are very quick to cover up for their goaltender. Pearson that time was in hoping for a loose puck. And he was decked.
That's the way it should be. If you're going to fool around in the crease, you're going down. Name me a coach in this league that doesn't love that about his team. And name me an opposing player that likes it. Very few, if any, of either. Weinrich dumps Pearson to make sure there's no trouble or no loose puck. Tough to score when you're on the way down.
A minute 10 left of the period, and you look at Doug Gilmore working it in there again.
This is the one Wendell Clark tries to go for the upper corner over the glove hand of Belfour and puts it about 8 inches too high.
He went for that top corner on the glove side of Belfour and missed it. Manderville, Pearson, and Eastwood. 52 seconds left in the power play for Toronto. Ruutu will be one forward and Roenick the other for Chicago.
These are the kind of delays Chicago like. Eddie Belfour pointed out to the linesman a hole in the crease, and so the linesman repairs it. Now, I'm not suggesting there isn't one. Remember in Chicago in game four, Chelios changing sticks, the trainer running out of the ice. Chicago doesn't play as many players in key spots as do the Leafs. And in this case, killing a penalty off, this is a break for the Chicago Blackhawks.
Big break with that linesman. He's really doing a tidy job. Lazarowicz. All right, face off to the left of the Chicago net. Minute 10 left of the period, 52 seconds. The Chicago penalty, no score. Eastwood got the draw. Back to Gill, he lost it. Fell, put it ahead. Two Blackhawks getting out, one man back. Roenick had a tough time controlling it. Goes in for the shot. Hutman blocked it into the final minute. Period one. Pearson giving a bump. He saw the hit coming and couldn't play it ahead. 45 seconds left of the period. 25 seconds on the Leaf power play. Todd Gill, he spots Eastwood going for the net. The backhander blocked by Belfour. Big rush by Eastwood on a nice setup. And he got right in on top of Belfour, who stopped him.
Well, other than Chelios and Suter, I think the scouting report on the other four Hawk defensemen, go wide. Go wide and make them take you. If they can take you, you can still get the puck into the zone. If they can't make the turn like Carney can't, you may get a good chance. Don't take them off the hook by going inside if you've got any speed at all. Go wide and challenge the defense. Todd Gill, lucky he got the puck deep or it would have been a 3-on-1. And as you said, Bob Roenick fumbled the puck there or he'd have been away in the 2-on-1. He does get a good shot away.
Right at the goaltender though, and Puffman just stood up and took it. 33 seconds left of the period. Score from the faceoff. Chicago getting on it quickly. Graham shooting it down the ice. That will just about kill the penalty. Only 9 seconds left on it. Cuddyworth ready to come back on the ice. The Leafs move it up. 3 seconds. He'll be on. And Rouse shoots it in. Chicago players out of the penalty box. There he is. Cuddyworth tipped it down the ice. And the Chicago player Suter is knocked down. Deep in his own zone in front of Belfour, he's hurt.
I didn't see how it happened. I didn't see whether Koharski called a penalty. But there are 10 seconds left in the period. Suter has not got up or now is getting up. The trainer's looking at him. When the referee looks at him, you have to think there might be a penalty. Anyway, here we're going to see it. Chelios turns and his stick comes up and hits Gary Suter right in the face. So unless, and don't forget, the rush was coming up the other way. So you wonder whether Koharski saw it or not. But of course, a linesman can help the referee on high sticks. And I think that they're telling Koharski it was, in fact, Chelios' stick.
Looks like a cut around the eye, and Suter will go on to the Chicago dressing room for repairs with only 10 and a half seconds left in the period.
Now, I asked Daryl Sutter, how can these guys, Chelios and Suter, play as much as they do? We know they're two big horses. Sutter said, I'm not sure. All I know is we've got a trough of water and two oat bags on the bench for them between shifts. After a good shift, we toss in a carrot or an apple, and then we say, you two Clydesdale shift is up next.
Okay, the puck is dumped down to the Chicago line, and that'll do it. Chelios will try a long shot for puck back. Couldn't beat the horn with that one. He did put it right on the net, though. And the shots in the first period. Toronto 12, Chicago 7. Coming up on our first intermission, Don Cherry will be in the coach's corner. And the score at the end of the first period here at Maple Leaf Gardens, Toronto nothing, Chicago nothing.
Any deodorant will do if you're at a standstill. But movers and shakers need the clean, fresh power of Speed Stick. It's 110% wide stick protection for movers and shakers. Speed Stick, the wide stick.
To build a winner, you gotta have hardworking guys you can depend on. A good, solid enforcer. Great move. Tough in the corners. And not afraid to go to the net. The only thing better than one good enforcer is two good enforcers.
Now at your Ford and Mercury dealers for a limited time, get F-Series Enforcer with airbag, rear ABS, and more. Only $13,744. Or choose Enforcer 4x4. Now only $16,244.
Enforcer's tough enough for me and Blue. And Blue is one tough pup. Bushy, too.
I have a blind date tonight, and you know what they say about first impressions. Do I reveal my nutritious, ready-for-commitment side with 100% whole wheat? Or do I let loose the fun-loving Mr. Mini Wheat with my great-tasting light frosting? I really want her to like me.
Then show her both sides, Mr. Mini Wheat.
You think so?
Yeah, show her everything a Mini Wheat from Kellogg's has got, and she'll be back for more.
She'll never leave my side.
Well, now, Mr. Mini Wheat.
She'll be my true love forever.
Oh. Let's not get carried away.
Something was missing from M.L. Pogue's life.
Whenever you go to sleep, you lose your memory.
What?
Now he doesn't remember who he is.
Kiss me. Her name is Sarah Novak. I think you're in love with her.
What he knows.
Are you my dog? I do. Is that?
Rusty.
Or where he's been.
Then we went here, here, down here, and ended up here.
Dana Carvey, clean slate.
This was one of the people who laughed at us.
Starts Friday, May 6th at theaters everywhere.
Any deodorant will do if you're at a standstill. But movers and shakers need the clean, fresh power of Speed Stick. It's 110% wide stick protection for movers and shakers. Speed Stick, the wide stick. By men.
Some guys are into bodybuilding. And some of us like to support the local artistic community.
Is that her? I don't feel a thing.
One of these. Some guys don't mind doing the shopping.
Definitely one of these.
Some guys like to keep their emotions to themselves. Some guys.
Oh, yeah.
Some guys drink X.
Corner with Don Cherry, brought to you by Pepsi. Be young, have fun, drink Pepsi.
To discover the real difference between the world's two leading soft drinks, we're implementing an anthropological study. Chimp A will be allowed nothing but Coke. Chimp B, nothing but Pepsi. The results are astounding. The chimp that drank Coke showed improvement in motor skills. The chimp that drank Pepsi, however, disappeared.
Hello? It's him.
Hey,
Got a nice tire what? You know what you call me, eh?
Yeah.
Call me a big pansy.
Since 1979, you've been burned by a flower. What do you think of the game?
Oh, jeez.
Keep up. We got lots to go through here. 5 minutes.
All right. I'll tell you. I like the game. I like Ronick. I like that Ronick and Gilmore, too. They can play in any era. I got to tell you, remember he got a cross-check Ronick in the teeth? I got to tell you a story about him. A Featherstone for Boston cross-checked him in the face and in the teeth, and he got a two-minute minor. And he went around. This is a true story. He knocked out two of his teeth. He went around, found them, put them on his tongue, and went up to the referee and went like that and got a five-minute major.
Right, for Featherstone. And then he went out and scored, right? Isn't that what happened, as I recall?
Something like that.
Weren't you going to show something here about Jeremy
Ronick? Yes, I'm going to show you when you people didn't see the great interview that you did. Better interviews that you did. We had to run to the news right away, so I just want to show you a little thing. I love seeing these guys after they scored the overtime goal in Chicago. Okay, let's see it. Go ahead, roll it right now. Now, here it is. Here he comes.
Let's wait a minute before the eyes have it.
Here we go.
The eyes have it, Jerry boy. There it go.
The perfect Don Cherry's. There you go.
What I say next is really scintillating, but you didn't want to show that. No, I'm kidding, of course. But there, Kirk Muller, you'd love to have seen him last night, although he wasn't on at all. He'll be on, I guess, tomorrow.
How about the Habs and Bruins last night? Is that something to watch that game last night?
I got a question before we get to that.
Oh, yeah?
You know, you mentioned Ronick and you mentioned Gilmore, yes. And we've talked about Suter and Chelios as a tandem.
Yeah.
I just think there's a lot of people who wonder about the other guys on the teams. Do you think Stars are playing too much, and are the line matchups getting to be too much when you're 8 weeks?
Well, what happens is a lot of people, I hear, they're playing too much, they're tired and that. They're never tired. Anybody that played the game will tell you they'd rather play a little tired. And Chelios will tell you, Gilmore will tell you, a little tired. It takes that little edge off. They don't get nervous. I asked Bobby Orr. The same thing. He says, I always played better, a little tired all the time. And that's the way they want to play. And that's what happened to Guy Lafleur. You mentioned Guy Lafleur. When Guy Lafleur, Jacques Lemaire took over, he didn't play that regular shift, the power play, and kill penalties. That's what happened to him. He wasn't that little tired. And that's why he had to retire.
It was funny. You know, Habs in Montreal, Jacques Lemaire and Eddie Johnston were key victories in the other series. But let's talk. We only got 2.5 minutes, and you got a lot on Robertson.
Well, okay.
Let's talk first about the Bees and the Habs.
Well, let me tell you. I know Serge Savard and Jacques they're boxing fans. And I tell you one thing that they saw. You remember the thrill in Manila? It was George Foreman and Al Lee. And what he did was, what Al Lee did, he laid on the ropes and he let George pound him. And then when George was so tired, he just fell down and he knocked him out. That's what their plan was. Let the Boston guys fire pucks at him and wear themselves out and then put it in the net. I'll tell you,
Jacques wanted 60 shots a game.
I'll tell you something, boys. 60 shots. They should give half their pay, or if they win the Stanley Cup to Roy on that one. By the way, you see the guy that come through was Muller. I got to tell you a true story. I know we don't have that. In the overtime, I went out to make a sandwich. This is a true story. And Muller scored. Muller scored. And by the time I got back with the sandwich, we were off the air. I never saw it. I switched over to the French channel and saw it anyhow.
Well, it was great. Third time he scored in overtime.
Yes.
Gilmore's got 3-0
yes.
And all these people from
Kingston. Must be the water or the beer.
Gary Roberts, he wanted to praise
Gary him. Gary Roberts, let me tell you something. Cam Neely type, I'll tell you right now. Here he comes now. You know, a lot of guys say, is he a playoff guy? What is he? He plays hurt. The guy's got a bad shoulder. He's got a bad back. Watch this guy take all his pounding and everything. This is why I say Calgary will be in the finals. They get new and dice back.
Win.
I said, no, I'm going to give you a smack if you keep that up. I told you. Now watch him here in front of the net. This is what I call my type of guy. You said he looked like one of those Bronco bull rider guys. That
really does look like a cowboy.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, boy, he never quits. He's right there all the time. He's a leader, I'll tell you that. Look at him. Watch this one. This is a beauty. And I think he gets up and gets one more whack. Anyhow, I just wanted to show that. What kind of, we don't see in the East. We don't see what's going on in the West with Gary. Here he goes with Burry. Talking about Burry, you know, everybody thinks I'm going to start gloating now because Burry hasn't got a goal and he's not playing so well. I have more respect for Burry now than when he was floating, getting 60, because he hasn't quit. The kid is pressing. He's trying his best. It just shows you some of our Canadian heart is rubbing off on him.
All right. Don Cherry with lots of great thoughts, including his sandwich. You didn't mention the ice cream, but why would we talk about the thrilla in vanilla? In this installment of the Coach's Corner, I'm Olson, Hockey Night in Canada, and the Stanley Cup playoffs on CBC.
Coach's Corner with Don Cherry. Brought to you by Pepsi. Be young, have fun, drink Pepsi.
Pick up your copy of Mrs. Doubtfire today before someone else grabs it.
Back off!
Don't miss the hottest deal on video.
My first day as a woman, I'm getting hot flashes.
$24.98 or less.
Surprise.
Buy Mrs. Doubtfire today.
Help! Now at Red Lobster.
Well, we've got a new special tonight. It's got everything.
Scampi tails and two kinds of your favorite shrimp. Start with our scampi tails, sweet and tender. Add savory sizzling garlic shrimp. Then our famous grilled shrimp to top off a terrific dinner.
It's new.
It's scampi tails and shrimp two different ways for a limited time. You're gonna love it.
Only at Red Lobster.
CFNY 102.1, the leading edge. FNY 102.1.
New music first.
Hey, let's make Mom a car. What do you want to say?
I love you and you're pretty.
And?
I'm sorry I broke the lamp.
Anything else?
You're pretty.
Again?
It's important.
Okay.
Introducing Carlton Cards Create a Card.
You're sorry? I'm pretty?
Now you can make a card that says just what you want. Carlton Cards Create a Card.
Nobody makes a card for that, except me.
I tried to stop.
I just kept going back.
I can't control myself.
What's harder to resist than Orville Redenbacher's buttered popcorn? New Redenbutters. More buttery taste than you can imagine. Drizzled over every square inch of Orville's butterfly kernels.
I love it.
In two irresistible flavors, movie theater butter and zesty butter. New Redenbutters.
It's cool.
It's one of sport's ultimate achievements, having a place with the elite. The new Hockey Hall of Fame honors almost 300 of the game's greatest contributors. Throughout the postseason, we present many of them on hockey's Great Wall. It's brought to you by Ford of Canada, a proud founding sponsor of the Hall of Fame and makers of the 1995 WinStar. Tonight, a Bruin who excelled at both ends of the ice, Milt Schmidt, is next.
New Ford WinStar, I'd say it's the evolution of the minivan. I've never heard of another minivan that has all of these safety features standard.
The dual airbags.
Yeah, four-wheel anti-lock brakes.
Those things that...
This reinforced side beams are...
They make me feel really comfortable driving my children in a car where I know they're safe. I like the fact that there's a child-proof safety lock on the sliding door. The 24-hour roadside assistance. I like to know I can call and get help right away. The Ford WinStar, that's great. Safety is so important to me. It has to be one of the most important things when you're a mom.
Milt Schmidt was inducted into Hockey's Hall of Fame in 1961. Few ever to play the sport have possessed the great all-around ability he did. Good stick handler, good shot, good sixth sense that enabled him to be in position to use his strong skating. But he was famous for being tough. The wars with Detroit's Blackjack Stewart are legend. Milt was known for his centering role on Boston's Crowd line. He scored 229 goals. He won the scoring title and the Hart Trophy as MVP and helped Boston to a pair of Stanley Cups. Four-time All-Star, who was a great NHL executive, tonight we focus on Milt Schmidt on Hockey's Great Wall. Presented by Ford of Canada, makers of the 1995 WinStar, the proud founding sponsor of the new Hockey Hall of Fame and Museum.
Canadian Tire has earth-shaking news for everyone who owns a car. For 2 weeks only, quality North American-made Motomaster AS tires are unbelievably priced. As part of a limited-time special buy, 13-inch Motomaster AS tires are just $25 installed, 14-inch are $35 installed, and 15-inch are only $45 installed. We will not be undersold, so hurry. Time is running out. Offer ends Saturday, April 30th.
There's a lot more to Canadian Tire for a lot less.
You're looking at one Canadian. Over the next year, his food bill will likely rise 2%. His rent, 4%. To some, rising costs are a fact of life. But with Royal Bank's extended freeze on service prices, his banking costs won't go up. It's a little thing. But if it helps one customer, it's worth it. After all, we got to be Canada's largest bank. One customer at a time.
In an increasingly complex world, we cut through the clutter. CBC News World. Immediate. Accessible. First. Find this symbol in your TV listings and stick with it. CBC News World. Canada's news and information network, 24 hours a day. We go the distance to bring you a Canadian view of the world. CBC News World. News on the hour. Information around the clock.
I still cannot accept that a 38-year-old lady just died yesterday because we couldn't help her enough. Nuclear technology allows me to see problems as they evolve instead of waiting for the damage to be done. People are frightened of the word, but they don't even know how it is applied to our field.
If you have any questions about nuclear technology, waste, or safety, call this number for your booklet.
People should ask questions before closing their minds to this new technology.
For the first time, there's a saw that combines dust collection, an auto brake, and a powerful 3-year warranty. So there's no limit to what you can build. Introducing the Quantum Circular Saw. New from Black & Decker.
Think you know baseball? Get in the game. Play to win with ProLine from Sports Select. Pick the right teams, you win cash. All you gotta do is make the right call. You're out!
You're crazy!
You're still out!
This portion of Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC was brought to you in part by Ford of Canada, where quality is job one.
Second period coming up at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. No score after the first 20 minutes. The shots by Toronto 12 and by Chicago 7. There's Eddie Belfour, ready to go to work for period number 2. And of course, Felix Puttman down to our left this time, limbering up. Koharski comes to center ice. These two teams tied at 2 games apiece. So far, nobody able to win on the road. Eastwood against Sutter. Brent Sutter won the draw. It's kicked back by Isebard. Rain the other forward for Chicago. Pearson and Manderville, the wingers for Toronto. An icing call against the Blackhawks.
Well, although the Leafs didn't capitalize on any of their 12 shots on goal, they did play a pretty strong defensive period. And that's the key to their success. Gilmore 931, Roenick 659. Gilmore played on 2 different lines, 9 shifts, a little more than a minute each. Chelios, he's well on the way to another 35 or 34 minute game in regulation. So is Suter. Suter got hurt at the end of the first period, but he's back.
Face off deep in the Chicago zone to the right of Belfour. Chicago on the puck. It is Chelios looking for a little bit of room. The pass intercepted. It is Pearson in with a shot. And it's blocked by Belfour. Faked the first one, stepped in another bit, and then took a shot from a sharp angle. Isebard poked it to center ice. Brent Sutter chasing it. Manderville had him covered. And Rouse was able to get back. Kirk Graham is pressing in there. It is centered. Pearson knocked one down and skates out. Manderville rolled it from the Chicago line and behind the net and then heads off. The Leafs change. The Blackhawks get it to center. Rouse poked it back in. Pearson was late getting out. Now he's off. Kearney's pass is stopped by Rouse. Roenick nearly stole it from Rouse. McCown bumped by Roenick. Murphy comes in to help for Chicago. Puck along the boards, and there's Clark. Up to Gardner. He overskates it. Blackhawks tearing there after it. Monty and McCown caught him. Murphy was upended in front of the net. Chicago line, Chelios takes Clark in on the boards. Gilmore couldn't pick it up, and here's Amonte. Through center is Chelios, winding up the shot. Puck band is saved. Big rebound is slapped high into the crowd. As Chelios went in there looking for it.
Well, Pat Burns is getting the matchup most of the time he's looking for. That is Lefebvre and McCowan against the Roanoke group. Roanoke and his boys had 9 shifts in the first period, 6 of them. They got McCowan and Lefebvre out there. That's about as well as you can get it. Now, Pearson makes a real fine play on this shot early in the second period. You know how far out Belfour comes. Fake it, go wide, there's got to be a hole. Belfour recovers to make the save. He's a chance-taking goalie, a bright idea, and a good opportunity for Pearson.
Minute 41 into the second period, and it's scoreless. Remember, in game 2 here in Toronto, they played 3 periods. Nobody could score. Gill in overtime. Ended it. Gilmore was upended, so the Leafs had to come back and start again. Allen around the net. He swings in there rather quickly. Can't control the puck. Borshevsky does. And gets it out down the ice, and Gilmore gives chase, and Belfour is away out of the net. Chelios stalling Gilmore. They push and shove. Here's Allen. Gets a low shot. There again to stop it.
I think Anderchuk, if he had another chance on this one, he'd get out about 4 feet further. He was too close. You can see he doesn't have time to get out, but he's about 4 feet away from Belfour and can't get the tip up high enough soon enough. Here's Anderchuk. The puck goes around to Ellett. Now, if Anderchuk's out another 3 feet and gets more of the puck, it's up and over Belfour. Anderchuk, that's the kind of goals he lifts off. Belfour's tough tonight.
.213 into the second. Leafs with 2 scoring chances so far in the period. The Blackhawks 1 on the Chelios shot, but from a distance. Face off. It's kicked back to the line of Lefebvre. His shot. So good to center, and they move it up. Murphy gets to the Leaf line and then lost it. And the penalty is now called.
Zezel's going to get it, I think, for goaltender interference. He's going to plead his case to Koharski that he was knocked into him. But there's supposed to be 0 tolerance on goaltending interference. It hasn't been called a lot, but when Belfour lives that far out of the crease, you can see that Roanoke kind of steers Zezel into him. I'm not so sure that's the penalty that Koharski thought it was.
That's it. Goaltender interference. 235. Chicago's power play 0-for-2 in the game. Remember, we keep talking about the first score between these two teams, looming so large.
Well, the Leafs win games playing good defensive hockey. Won games 1 and 2, 1 goal against. Lost games 3 and 4, 9 goals against.
Chelios will take it away from the goalie and get around with it. A little bit of room for him up the middle, and against the center to shoot it in. Here comes Amonte. Suter lugging the puck up to center ice. Putting it into the left of Potvin. Count around the net. Up along the boards to Gilmore. He decides to skate with it a bit more. Comes in there. Gilmore gets a shot. Love save by Belfour, but what a play by Doug Gilmore. Is he something or what? Gilmore coming back to hit Chelios ship for Gilmore again.
If it isn't Gilmore, it's Gronick. What a pair of beauties these two guys are. Gilmore in a shorthanded situation, nearly snuck his way by everybody to get a chance to put the Leafs ahead. Genius in this game is the infinite capacity to give pain. And what a pain Gilmore is to the Chicago Blackhawks. Gronick throws a big hit on Jamie McCowan. And that's what you like about these two guys. They get hit, they hit. They know it's part of the game. They don't like it any more than anyone else to get drilled. You rarely see them whining about it.
45 seconds left on the Leaf penalty. No score in the hockey game. Allen snapped one on the boards, and Berg was there to pick it up. A loose puck and gets it out. Rouse comes in there to shoot it. Fake the shot. Now the drive. And Belfour the save. He was away out of the net again. Kearney was skating right alongside Bob Rouse, making sure he couldn't get near the net.
Well, Belfour comes out more than any other goalie in the league more often on bad angle shots especially. And so what looks like a 45-foot shot here is actually a 25-foot shot, or a 30 at the most. Belfour gives up a little reaction time to take away a little bit of the angle. It's worked perfectly for him. He's been a fine goaltender in this league.
30 seconds left in the penalty to Peter Zazzle of the Maple Leafs. Chicago's power play winding down. Gilmore had a rest for about 20 seconds. He's back out again, broke his stick on the faceoff. Races over there to get a new one as the Blackhawks come out. Pass to the right side to Jeremy Roenick. Breaking in there, Dubinsky in too far for his shot, but here's Roenick again. Roenick all the way back to the line, taking his time. Now trying to beat Gilmore, and he couldn't. Gilmore going down, there has Gardner ahead of him and trying to slip the pass up. But Kearney blocked it. There's Gilmore again, whipping it in, and Gardner skated right by the puck. The penalty is over. Zazzle is on the ice. It is Weinrich coming in. Shot it in wide of the net. Ellett picked it up before it got out front. And he's forced to go into the corner against Ruutu. Christian tried to knock it loose and did. It comes to the line. This shot is blocked by Gardner. Chicago lifting it in. The crowd trying to get the Toronto team on the board. 17 shots to 8 for Chicago. No score. Belfour will come out. He'll see the defenseman Greg Smith come back. Got him lined up. Decided not to hit him. Puck is at the blue line. Leafs keep it in. Wendell Clark sandwiched in there. Two Blackhawks were on him. Dirk and Cunnyworth. Here's Cunnyworth. He should have stopped at the line. This will give the Leafs the chance to turn it back out. The Blackhawks take the opportunity to change. We are nearing the 6-minute mark of the second period. Still no score. Clark tipped one to center. Loose puck taken by Suter. He and Chelios exchange passes. Up the center. Gilmore is hitting everybody. He lined up Eisenhardt that time and drilled him. McCown goes around the net. Played it high. Nobody could clear it out. Gilmore is there again with Clark, and he gets it ahead. Gardner won't reach it. The Blackhawks' Eisenhardt shoots it back in. Nearing the 7-minute mark of the second. Eisenhardt on the boards, waits for the puck to come out, maybe. Gilmore poked it back. Hotbass stepping out of the net to the corner. Lefebvre bump. Gilmore got a nice pass away to Clark. He's grabbed from behind, but here comes McCown. He can't beat Chelios. We'll go on the power play when we come back in this scoreless game.
TD is the only bank that gives you a mortgage with up to 5 different rate and term combinations. With a TD multi-rate mortgage, you won't get locked into a high interest rate or out of a low one. TD, your bank, your way.
That's the house I grew up in. I'm still there, too.
Eisenhardt had a physical shift there. Finally took a hooking penalty.
Now he hooked a needless penalty, a hook from behind. You remember I mentioned that's one of Koharski's favorite calls, fouls from behind.
Leafs power play. Shot deflected wide of the Chicago net, and Belfour had his eye on that. It hit the boards down low, popped up over the net, and there he was to glove it. 0 for 3 on the power play in the game. Toronto, although one of their power plays was a very brief one, 14 seconds.
Belfour sharp. When you see goalies find the puck on a deflection or a rebound off the glass or the boards behind them before anybody else does, as he did there when he caught it, you know he's following that puck, and his reactions are number one.
Face off to the left of Belfour. Roenick at the bench. He'll go off for now.
The linesmen are hurrying the Hawks up on the changes. They think that the Hawks are trying to stall and get extra time between the faceoffs.
Leafs have Gilmore, Borshevsky, Andrejczuk, Marinov, and Ellen Marinov fake the shot. Gave it to Borshevsky, coming in with a drive. Up high, and it bounced to the side of the net. Andrejczuk to Borshevsky. He's waiting on the outside, and here's Gilmore, just missed the pass. Andrejczuk just missed it. The Blackhawks a chance to clear if Chelios can move it, but he can't. Borshevsky worked it in there. Side. There's Andrejczuk, far side with it. Ellen Pop at the blue line, off his stick and down the ice. Ellen chased by Brent Sutter. Now it bounces away from Gilmore. So Chelios will shoot at the length of the ice. 1:15 left in the penalty to Eisenbart of Chicago. No score, second period. Gilmore's pass to Borshevsky. Up with Gartner, he backhands it in. Gartner had to wait at the blue line as Borshevsky had made another move. Now a penalty coming out to Toronto, and that was a penalty against Kearney, the injury. Kearney was injured, and the referee is checking him.
Well, Borshevsky tried to lift the stick up from behind, missed, and came up and clipped Kearney in the face. 2 minutes, no blood. And here it is here. You see, Kearney's got the edge on Borshevsky. Borshevsky tries to lift up his arm or his stick, misses it, and hits him in the face. Down he goes. The power play is over.
Number 16, Nikolai Borshevsky, 7:46.
7:46, the time of the penalty, so there will be a minute and 5 second power play for Chicago when Eisenbart comes back. And you see the action around the Chicago net.
If you live in front of the net like Andrejczuk does, you're going to get cross-checked. You're going to get held. You're going to get harassed. You score 50 in this league, you're a marked man.
So find a side for now for 55 seconds. No score, second period. 7:46 gone. Puck to the Chicago line. Zezel knocked it down with his glove, and I think that's why they stopped the play. Do it again, just outside the Chicago line.
Well, neither team has drawn any blood in this 4-on-4 situation. There haven't been a lot of them in this series. Both teams scored two more than they had scored against them during the season when they were both a man short. Neither one has been able to get one in this, the fifth game of this series.
45 seconds left in the Paul Eisenbart penalty. Minute 48 in the Toronto penalty, of course, to Borshevsky. He's off for high sticking. Chicago moving up smartly. Roenick, pumped by Bird. Two players on the ice. Puck loose. Kearney kept it in. Now the Leafs' Bird gets it up to center to Zezel. He's trying to pull away. It was grabbed by Amonte. Fought it off and kept going. Zezel around the net. Centered it. And Amonte is there in front of the goalie to pick it up and skate away with it. He's up near the Leaf line where he loses control. Ruutu on it quickly. Gilmore took it from him, and here's Bill Berg again. Circles back. Amonte trying to take it from him. Gilmore now in control. One good move. And his stick grab didn't matter. He kept going. Gilmore spun around twice on that rush, and he still has it. Gilmore working it up along the boards. He stopped Chelios. bench. Chicago moving up on a power play now. And they shoot it in. Lafay to Manderville. Now Dave Ellen up to center ice. Decides to roll it in there along the boards. 30 seconds left in the penalty to Borshevsky. Manderville caught his man. The Blackhawks get on it, and Murphy goes down across center. He's over the Leaf line. It's dropped back to Roenick. Roenick couldn't get in. Ellett standing in front of the net. Lafay spins away from a hit. Ellett is caught by Roenick. Lafay rescues the puck behind the net and gets it out, and look who's on the ice again. Number 93, Gilmore. And the penalty has been killed. Borshevsky is out of the box. Blackhawks move up. Brent Sutter's shot. Comes right back to him off Ellett. Sutter shoots into the boards in the corner, and it makes the big circle all around the net to the line. Good shot, an easy save. Caught that. And the play is called with 9:57 remaining in the second. No score.
Road 0-0 halfway through the series, 2-2. Both these coaches could take some advice from the great Yogi Berra, the New York Yankee Hall of Famer, who once said, when you come to the fork in the road, Bob, take it.
And he was right. He was always right.
Trappy. When the ball came in as a fork ball, he didn't take it too often. He drove it.
9:57 left in the second. No score. And the Leafs get the puck out of the zone. Down the ice. Belfour was going to come out. Clark is in there. Had his man lined up. Looked like he was going to throw a hit on Carney. Backed off at the last second. And the Blackhawks shoot it to center, and they move up on it. Christian tried to go in. Here's Clark. He lost it, but Gartner grabs it. Backhands it over the line. Chelios knocked it down. Out with Dubinsky. Dubinsky to center. Played it ahead. The Leaf line is Christian trying to find room to get in. He centered it, and Gartner was back. A pass through the line at center. Gilmore moving up, and here's Gartner going to get a goal! And a great save by Belfour, with Gartner speeding it off the wing from the blue line now. The shot deflected wide. He bumps it down in front of the net, and Clark just missed it. The Chicago Blackhawks relieve the pressure and get it out as the Leafs period. 8:50 left. Suter going around the net. Manderville for checking. Chelios takes it. Chelios shooting it to center. McCown knocked it down and lifted it too high. It's over the boards at the Leaf bench. 20-9 are the shots in favor of Toronto. In the broadcast booth. Ron McLean, Don Cherry, along with us, Hockey Night in Canada, bringing you this game, Game 5, Chicago and Toronto, on the CBC Network, coast to coast. And the makings of another dandy tonight between these two. Rich Sutter leaves it for Roenick, speeding in. Roenick on the outside of Gill, gets him back in the net, and Gill caught him. And he held him there, but Roenick still fights for it. It is shot around the boards, however. Comes right back to him, and Manderville will get it out. Manderville's pass. Banked in for Pearson. Reaching for it, and Rich Sutter got back to stop him from getting a shot. Sutter and Pearson. Kick it loose. Goes back in on the boards. Manderville is there now with Pearson. Eastwood. Eastwood pulling away from a hit. Then he upended the Chicago player, but the play continues. The Blackhawks get it up to center and down the ice. Brent Sutter giving chase. Todd Gill is back. And icing is called against Chicago. Brent Sutter and Gill have words.
Well, it's been all Leafs in the second period. I know it doesn't show on the scoreboard. The shot's 8-2. The chance is 5-0. The question is, will the Leafs be rewarded for what may be their best period they've played, at least in the last two games? Kiefer Sutherland, the son of the great actor Donald Sutherland, is at the game tonight. Don't you remember his movies? Young Guns, Flatlanders, and others I haven't seen.
Eye of the Needle. And on, and on, and on.
I know one thing. If he's nearly as good as his father, career on the horizon for him. The eagle has landed, Donald Sutherland. He landed right in the garden. He's playing goal for the Hawks.
.739 left in the second.
The worst thing that could happen to the Leafs now is Chicago, on the first chance of this period, put it in. That would be a deflator.
Belfour poised. Leafs win the draw. Rouse, weak shot. Belfour gloved it. And another faceoff coming in the Chicago zone. Feel the Blackhawks can sense the Leafs have it going well here in the second period. And they're not taking any chances now, clearing it out, and Belfour every opportunity is fawning on it. And they'll live with these faceoffs until it cools a bit. If it cools a bit. Cray on the draw, and somebody is thrown out. Brent Sutter is out. Cray stays in. Pat Burns has McCray now with Borshevsky and Andrejczyk. And he won the draw. Rouse gets a shot. Oh, it was a weak shot, all right. And full Belfour, he missed it. But fortunately for Belfour and the Blackhawks, it was just wide of the post. Amadi coming in. Amadi put off stride of the Leafs, poke it back to center, and Chelios ripped it back in there. Bob Rouse through the middle with it. To nobody in particular, it rolls inside the Chicago line. Suter and Chelios. Right onto the stick of Amadi. He's down with a pass to center left wing. Brent Sutter shot. Off the blocker of Potvin. Saw it all the way. Amadi after it again, centered it. Sutter came close right there. They think Mironov has been injured. Loose puck in front of the net, the play stopped. Mironov was checked low.
Koharski saw it, but I can tell you one thing, Mironov felt it.
Chris Broadhurst is out there now talking to him, and you can almost read his lips. This is killing me. I think it's my knee, and he's still down. So Mironov in pain, and he is being assisted to his feet now. And there he goes, dragging the one on the left side. We'll be back.
On the near, you can see it. Right knee. Mironov goes off with his right knee sore. No penalty. And at the same time, the trainer was out to see Mironov. The Hawk trainer came out. Gave Belfour a little whiff of the smelling salt. Koharski's saying, you got to check with me before you come out. You can't just run out on the ice at any time. Belfour wasn't hurt, and you can't do that. Remember, they did it in Chicago twice. The Leafs objected. Koharski, no penalty on the call. 6:45 to go in the second period. Toronto nothing, Chicago nothing.
Has gone to the Leaf room, and what looked like a knee injury, however, we haven't heard for sure yet. When we do get word, we'll pass it along. Chicago will move up for this faceoff to the left of Potvin with 6:45 left in the second period. No score. Zezel for Toronto. Shoots the puck in an open wing, and there's Chelios. Ian Suter once again.
Ripoke it ahead, just away from Zezel. Zezel gets it anyway. Circles back to his own line for Lepage.
Up to Osborne. Osborne is moving it in slowly. Lifted it over the line and gallops in after it. Suter caught him. Berg went after it back at the net, and Christian had him covered. Christian is knocked down by Duke. apiece. Chicago's Cunningworth comes up to the leaf line. Couldn't get by Jamie McCown. McCown's back from behind. Here's the Leafs in with a shot. Gardner's backhander is stopped by Belfort. He dives out there and grabs it. Way behind the play, McCown was hit by Rich Sutter and flattened.
What a great play by Gilmore to run a little interference. He knew he couldn't touch the puck or he would have been offside. He knew Gardner was coming late. There's Gilmore up ahead of Gardner. He takes out Chelios. That allows Gardner to walk in to the dot and fire one. But again, Gardner with a great chance, or Clark with a great chance, can't beat him. And then Gardner gets a backhander. Belfour doing his impression of Patrick Waugh here tonight at Maple Leaf Garden.
5:49 left in the second. Brent Sutter will try to win it from Gilmore, and he does. Blackhawks now line up. They're very patient, moving the puck slowly through center ice. A good clearing play. Not to Brent Sutter, but he lost it. And Gilmore gives it to Gardner. Gardner will hold it down. And there's a penalty called against Tony Amonte of Chicago. As Gardner tried to go in to create a two-on-one, he was hooked, as you see Dom Kuharski, and he's going off.
Foul from behind. You got to have a scouting report on the referees if you're smart. It was a dive. As soon as Gardner felt the stick between his legs, he took off. You can't make those kind of plays in the neutral zone from behind with Don Kuharski referee. He misses Stewart.
Toronto's fifth power play of the hockey game. There is no score in this one with the second period winding down. Now what a big game this one. Two games won by Toronto here, two games by Chicago there. The victor in this one is looking pretty good, wouldn't you say?
Well, Ron McLean gave us a stat before the game. Since 1987, when they started playing four best of sevens, only one team out of 17 that lost game five went on to win the series.
Puck is clear just in time with three Leafs coming in. Gill to Andrechuk. He left it. And Gilmore now on the ice again. Just dropped it back. Ellett moved it in a hurry. Up the center is Andrechuk down the wing for Gill, way out of his reach. 1:15 left in the penalty. 4:45 in the second period. Toronto back to take a good look at it again as Ellett. Being forced back by Roenick. Clark can't handle the pass. And the Leafs unable to get anything going on this power play. Crowd impatient, restless. The Leafs frustrated. And here's Gilmore to try. Green took it from him. Good penalty killing by Chicago right here. 45 seconds left in this power play by Toronto. Little over 4 minutes remaining in the period. No score. McCown decides to drill it in. Here's Gardner picking it up off the board. Back of the net. Gilmore working it loose in front. Clark was covered. Gilmore again. Clark is in front. The pass comes out and Ellett was pinching in from the blue line. Gilmore back of the net. Gilmore coming out front. Here's a shot. Down the floor. He stopped Gardner. As Gilmore worked it loose a couple of times and then spotted Gardner coming in. Put it on the tape. And Belfort choked off another alley. And Clark on the play gets a penalty.
A roughing call, Bob. He punched the Hawk player right in the face right after Gardner had that great opportunity to score. Here's the chance by Gardner. What a stop by Belfort, and then a left cross off the mask of Weinrich will cost the Leafs the power play. They only have 18 seconds left in it and give the Hawks one as this period draws to a close.
Yeah, I talked to Eric Weinrich this morning at length, and we talked about that face mask he has because he suffered a broken jaw, and he told me how uncomfortable it has been. And I'm keeping the guard on just in case. Well, that was a wicked left by Wendell Clark right on the guard.
Weinrich has played, Weinrich and Carney for the Hawks have really played very well. Until Smith and Russell got hurt, they were defensemen 5 and 6. Now they're defensemen 3 and 4. There's a huge difference in responsibility when that change occurs.
3:50 remaining in the period. And they're now 5 aside. But in 12 seconds from now, Chicago will get an opportunity on the power play. And they too are 0-for-4 in that department tonight. 4 seconds left in the Chicago penalty. Here's Amati on the ice. So the Blackhawks now have the extra man, and they move to center with 3:25 left in the period. Cecil steals the puck. Swept away by Chelios. And Amati gives it to Suter. Being watched by Cecil. Poked it ahead to Chelios. He's through the middle with it. It's broken up by Berg. And Berg stalls a bit before Lefebvre put a shot in. And once again, Belfour on those long shots does not look all that comfortable. He juggled that one. 3 minutes left in the period. 1:05 on the Chicago power play. And it's Amati coming down the right side. Backhands it off the boards behind Potvin. The Hawks move up for it now. Suter at the blue line. Chelios along the line. Murphy slides a pass in. Lefebvre got his stick on it. Murphy again around the net. Murphy played it back. And here's Chelios giving it back to him. Murphy near the line. He just barely kept it onside. Again, Chelios tries the shot. It's deflected and Potvin got a piece of it. Stopped on the other side by Suter. He got away from a hit from Osborne. Lefebvre hit his man in the corner. It is back to Chelios, winding up, no shot. He's out over the line with it. The pass on the Suter's skate. 24 seconds left in the Clark penalty. And the Leafs get the puck up to Gilmore. Gilmore worked it over the line. Suter carried it into the boards in the corner. 10 seconds left in the lead penalty, and it's down to center for Crane. Crane trying to go through everybody. And Puckman will stop the play. With 4 seconds left. And the Clark penalty at a minute 54 in the second period. And folks, we remain scoreless. There and took a shot. He was off balance and barely got the shot away. He did get it away, and Belfour made the save. The Leafs penalty is over. The two teams are at full strength, and you'll see this play develop. Gilmore intercepting and going in. He continues, Harry, to get a big round of applause. Score in this one so far. Minute 25 left. Second period. Chelios with a long shot. Potvin missed it. It bounced on the boards and came out front. And Gardner, slow and clearing it, got it up to Gilmore. Gilmore is upended near center ice. 1:10 remaining in the period. Gardner wrapped at it. Gilmore is there. It's in his skates. Brent Sutter pushed him off the puck. And the Leafs take it with a minute left.
Last minute of play in this period.
Up. Pass down near center, and Clark whips it into the Chicago zone. Gilmore was belted back there by Green. 45 seconds left in the second. Scoreless game again tonight. Puck near center ice, and Clark passes one in for Gilmore. Against Brent Sutter, there goes Wendell Clark along the boards, and Chelios took it away from him. 30 seconds left in the period. The Blackhawks, led by Jeremy Roenick, comes back in. He's over the line and trying to pull away from Lefebvre. And Lefebvre caught him. Sutter centered it. Rootsy was there. Got it back. Chelios shot. Blocked. And here's Gardner. Clark is up there. Couldn't get the lead pass, though. Belfour out of the net. Clark went after it. 5 seconds left in the period. And Cunnyworth from the Leaf blue line is bumped. To end the second period, and again they have not been able to get a goal.
Well, Hawks dodged the bullet in the second period, but you can't keep dodging it if you let the opposition shoot at you all night. Gilmore, Roenick, they battle with the puck. They battle without it. Have you seen two thoroughbreds lying behind the net in the National League any better than these two tonight?
Toronto out shooting Chicago 14-3 in the second period. And coming up in our second intermission after 40 minutes with Ron McLean. Tonight, Ron will chat with Paul Izebar of the Chicago Blackhawks. And the score after two periods. The Toronto Maple Leafs, nothing. The Chicago Blackhawks, nothing.
Would you use a deodorant soap on parts like these? On parts that are pretty? On parts that are cute? On the most sensitive parts of your birthday suit? You would if it's Lever 2000. Because Lever 2000 won't dry your skin like the leading deodorant soap. It's got the most effective skincare ingredients. So it's best for all your parts. On all your kin. On any place that you've got skin. Lever 2000. The deodorant soap that's best for your skin and all your 2000 parts.
That there are still some luxuries you can't afford.
I tried to stop.
I just kept going back.
I can't control myself.
What's harder to resist than Orville Redenbacher's buttered popcorn? New Redden Butters. More buttery taste than you can imagine, drizzled over every square inch of Orville's butterfly kernels.
I love it.
In two irresistible flavors, movie theater butter and zesty butter. New Redden Butters.
It's cool.
Hi, I'm Garrett. When I started Idomo 25 years ago, I stopped shaving. But with the beard and the company grew. These designs and prices are why. Why Idomo customers buy here again and again and refer us to friends. Value, design, and volume buying is Idomo. Come in for your new 94 catalog today. Your home, your domo, is Idomo. Idomo. The furniture is real, the value is real, and the beard is real.
When I think of summer, I think of just a little and a lot of. So having the right equipment's very important, and there's only one store I can think of.
After 40 minutes, brought to you by Bell Canada.
Back live at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, it's game five of the conference quarterfinal between the Hawks and the Leafs, and for the second time through two at the Gardens, nothing to report in the way of goals, and that'll concern a goal scorer. Paul Izebar joins me in our second intermission. Paul, I should ask you this before you sat down. Were you involved in the scoreless game Minnesota-Detroit a couple years back when Fedorov finally got, was it the replay goal?
Yeah, it went under the bar and nobody knew it was in or not. I didn't think it was in until they checked it up top on the top camera and seen the puck in the net.
Play had gone on, hadn't it, for a little while?
Yeah, the play never stopped. And then they finally called it and it took them a while to figure it out.
Shovel Day was great. Who was in goal, Casey for Minnesota?
I can't remember back that far, but... Anyways, both goaltenders played excellent.
Yeah, as they are tonight, let's talk about the game. What do you think of it so far?
Well, you know, being outshot the way we are, still, at the, you know, I watched that Montreal game last night, same thing. Just keep it scoreless and plug away, even if it takes to, you know, till midnight tonight.
You really get the feeling that it's a guy like you or Mike Gartner or somebody other than Roenick or Gilmore that's going to decide this thing. What are you trying to do to make that happen?
Well, just concentrate on the little things and keep the system the same. You know, that's a big part of it. It doesn't matter who scores now in the playoffs. It's just concentrating on the little things. And our system is just, being smart defensively, being in the right positions, and you can't really gamble against Toronto.
Right. You're with Brent and Dirk. That's a defensive line, to be sure. What about the fact that Don Cherry was discussing that star players love to play a lot, but here you are, a skilled player, not getting a chance to play as much ice. When you got your 35 goals twice and all those goals in Utica, has it really changed since the minute timeouts have come in?
Well, it's been, a little different here. The Blackhawk style is, like I said, you know, it's really tight contact hockey. You have to really rely on your defensive play. That's what he wants first and foremost, and hard work. But the breaks will come. You know, I'm just looking forward to putting a W on a Blackhawk win tonight. But scoring those goals in Detroit, it was, you know, I had a lot of opportunity on penalty killing, which keeps you involved in the game, and playing with Fedorov doesn't hurt either.
Yeah, you've answered this a lot, but when you go to Winnipeg with a nice contract, I know it was a breath of fresh air to get to the Hawks in the playoffs, but what kind of a season was it for you in terms of big dollars and few goals by your standards?
Yeah, it was a tough season, definitely, mentally. Right from the get-go, I started sitting out games up there, and of course that plays with your mind, and it was a tough, you know, I went there figuring I'd be there for a while, and unfortunately things didn't work out for whatever reason. I'm just trying to put that behind me and go forward in the playoffs.
Who supported you? Who got you? I met your wife in Winnipeg. I know she's a great gal, but how'd you get out of this?
It was tough. You know, I talked a lot with John Paddock as well, and I sat out, ended up sitting out 15 games, and when you come off the ice to warm up and you're waiting for a tap on the shoulder, it's tough to stay focused mentally, and it was a grind, but you know, I've learned it and become stronger from it.
Well, you made the most of moving over to Chicago. Goals quickly when they needed the most. Good luck in the third period.
Thanks, Ron.
Paul Eisenbart of the Chicago Blackhawks. The Hawks and the Toronto Maple Leafs are tied at zero through two periods of play in this critical Game 5. We'll have scores elsewhere and more when we continue on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
You know, when we decided to go out on our own, I admit we were scared. So we decided we'd better get a safety net.
Hello, Hooked on Fishing.
Presenting Advantage 800 Entry Service for small business.
Sure, we get lots of first-timers.
Canada's only 800 service for just $8 a month.
Hello, Hooked on Fishing.
Give us a call for your 800 number.
Honeymoon? Sure, why not?
And soon, out-of-town customers might drop you a line.
After 40 minutes, brought to you by Bell Canada. Live.
Tomorrow on the CBC Morning News, our live coverage of the South African election continues with the voice of black activism.
CBC Morning News on most of these CBC stations.
You're looking at one Canadian. At a time when small business owners run 98% of our businesses and employ one in three Canadians. To Royal Bank, his business is a cornerstone of the economy. That's why we've lowered his service charges by 10% for at least a year. A small break for small business. If it helps even one, it's worth it. After all, we got to be Canada's largest bank, one customer at a time.
What do you want from a telecommunications company?
Be there when I need you.
We're ready for you. Real bad.
Understand my concerns.
Careful, we'll give you a password up front.
Just keep me in the race.
Introducing a new approach to business communications.
We can't be a day late. We can't be an hour late. We have to be ready for the Commonwealth Games.
What we need to do now is a lot more testing with real users.
Well, that's easy. That's...
When overworked muscles or back pain hits, ice the pain with the cold treatment recommended by chiropractors. Deep cold therapy.
Well, we've got a new special tonight.
It's Red Lobster Scampi Tails and Shrimp Platter.
It's got everything.
Sweet Scampi Tails, plus two different kinds of savory shrimp for a limited time.
Only at Red Lobster.
Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, where the Hawks and the Leafs are embroiled in a scoreless tie through two periods of play. Again, to reiterate, since 1987, when the visiting team wins Game 5 after they've split the first four in the series, Visiting teams gone on to win 16 of 17 occasions. There have been 39 series split after four. The team winning game five has won 35 of 39. So a lot of the line here this evening. We'll bring you up to date on what happened in games five last night in a way of showing it just how important this is. But remember, it's got to be split after two. That wasn't the case with the Caps and Pittsburgh. Surely it was with these two teams. And there's Kirk Muller, the hero. 60 saves for Patrick Roy. Muller's third overtime career game-winning goal. Great effort for him. The Habs win. Jaromir Jagr's first goal of the playoffs. He and Kevin Stevens finally get it going. Pens are to within one in that series. And Claude Lemieux's two goals. Look at the beauty on Hasek there. Paved the way for a New Jersey victory at Brendan Byrne. They beat Buffalo. So then, as a result of those, we have, of course, eight series in the opening round. New York sweeps the Islanders. Tremendous effort for Mike Keenan's gang. Caps leads cut to one. The Canadians are up one coming home, and the New Jersey Devils go into the odd ahead by one. Detroit and San Jose plays this evening. Steve Yzerman's a probable for that game. The Calgary Flames lead Vancouver 3-1 as they get set to face it off at the Saddle Dome. We're tied, of course, in this series, and Mike Modano is a star of these playoffs. There's good news for Flames fans. Neuendijk's in. Of note, Gino Ogic and Murray Craven are scratches. Not injured, apparently, but scratches. Pat Quinn's made a decision. Dave King's got Neuendijk. No word on Joel Otto. He's definitely not in tonight. May not play the rest of the series. We'll show you some action from the Saddle Dome when we continue on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Hey, this new Pepsi Max is really something, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, it tastes of regular cola and a third of the calories.
I'll grab that for a second.
Yeah, sure.
What are you doing?
I want to see if they filled it up a third.
Can't you just enjoy the taste
without... That's the only way to explain this calorie thing.
You're not going to open it, are you?
Oh, don't worry. You see, the lower pressure created by the chilling will keep the expansionary forces of the carbon dioxide at bay.
He's going to open it.
It's elementary.
New Pepsi Max.
Oh, jeez.
All the taste, one third the calories.
Welcome to the prison of the future.
Prisoner 2675 has been delivered, sir.
There's no warden here, no guards, no cell. This is it. He's military trained, you realize that. Somebody taught him how to kill.
Ray Liotta.
We're outnumbered 6-1.
Now I'm gonna kill you.
No escape.
You want it? Come and get it!
Starts Friday, April 29th at theaters everywhere.
I'm a bit of a lawn freak. And people like me know the best stuff for lawns is at Canadian Tire. I go with SoGreen Premium Lawn Pro Fertilizer. It's got something called organic iron to make my lawn thicker and greener a lot longer. And SoGreen Weed and Feed is great at controlling weeds. And right now you can save $6 on each 18-kilogram bag. Yep, I've always had the best lawn in the neighborhood. Now all I need are neighbors.
The Home Project Sale. Don't miss it. There's a lot more to Canadian Tire for a lot less.
I want the truth. Not a song and dance. I want better, not more expensive. I want a car I can afford and like. Hey, I just want my money's worth. Okay, actually, I want more than my money's worth.
Till they start the third period in Toronto, let's enjoy the first period at Calgary.
At this time, we say hello to viewers across the country who have been watching action between the Maple Leafs and the Blackhawks at the Saddle Dome in Calgary. I'm Don Whitman along with Jim Paplinski and Ken Daniels. We played 1 minute and 1 second of the opening period and a couple of good scoring chances at both ends of the ice. James Patrick gets the center. Dumps it in. McLean comes well out of his net to leave it there for Hedekin. A couple of lineup changes for both teams. Joe Neuendijk is back in the lineup of the Flames. Mason Lafayette is dressed for the first time for Vancouver. Here's Bure with a weak backhander to the side of the net. Adams decides to go to the point. Brown lets the shot go. And Vernon has it and holds it for a faceoff.
Well, there's been a few lineup changes in the hockey game this evening. Murray Craven is out with back spasms. In his place is Nathan Lafayette. It's his first National Hockey League playoff game with the Vancouver Canucks. Carson Ogic, Slager, Plavsic, and Brian Glynn have been on the sidelines for the last couple of games. Joel Otto, of course, is out with a knee injury. Fatigue. Kesmer played the last game and played well. Dahlquist and Vitekoski. Dahlquist got a puck in the jaw this morning as we watch Nieuwendyk at warm-up testing his knee a little bit just to see how it felt. And he feels it's okay, and as a result, he's playing tonight.
Reichel banks one off the glass. Adams checked Fleury. He couldn't get to the puck. Reichel trying to move off the boards. Fleury is in there forechecking. Brown flips it up the left side for Adams. Adams into the neutral zone for Linden. Linden is checked. The puck is loose. Picked up by Bure. Bure for Hedekin. Hedekin works to the corner. Flips it back to the net. And Zalapski is back there after it. 17:53 remaining in a still scoreless opening period.
Here you go.
Okay, fellas, well, the third period is about to get underway here in Toronto. We are told that the Leafs will go with five defensemen for the third period. Dmitry Mironov checked by Dirk Graham in the second has a bruised right thigh. He will not return tonight. No score in the hockey game. Third period underway, game five. Jeremy Roenick in there to play it back to Suter, and his shot didn't get too far. It was blocked quickly. Roenick centered it. Christian centered it. And Berg turns it back for Toronto. Shooting a long one in. Now for the stick save and leaving it for Gary Suter around the net, and here he comes. Christian chopped it to center. Amati has to wait. Lefebvre had him covered. The Blackhawks are changing, so are the Leafs. Toronto comes up with Gilmore again. Dump the pass ahead. Here's a chance, but Borchevsky is offside. He was dumped anyway with three Hawks there, and somehow the little winger got through everybody, but he was offside.
Well, Borchevsky, a big heart. His problem some nights is the rest of his body isn't big enough, and he gets knocked down. He's offside on this play. He could have walked in, I think, but he gets knocked down from behind. And in a game with lots of hitting and close checking, Borchevsky doesn't get enough ice to show his talent.
We are in the first minute of the third period. Chelios to center ice, the long shot in, wide of the net, it bounced down, hot pass, steered it away for Ellett, he pulled away for Murphy. Ellett will come back out to center ice. Dave Ellett has some good speed up now. The rushing defenseman cleared it in. And Suter was allowed to go back to pick it up behind the net. Whipped it over there for Graham, and Gilmore stopped him. Gilmore on the boards. Graham poked it away. And again to center ice, Chicago. Murphy's pass in through, intended for Graham. Missed it. And it is called icing against Chicago.
Well, a couple of other town games on the docket tonight. Showed you a little bit of this game. It's still nothing-nothing. McLean versus Vernon as goaltenders in a game that can put Vancouver out of commission. Later on, San Jose attempts to get a leg up on the Detroit Red Wings. Remember, now it was two in Detroit. This is the third in San Jose in game six and seven if they have to play them all back in Detroit.
Where San Jose won a game.
Right on.
Must be exciting out there on the West Coast for San Jose. Tied with the heavily favored Detroit Red Wings. Two apiece. These two teams here in Toronto. Two apiece. Winning home games. Two here. Three and four in Chicago. Six will be in Chicago if seven is necessary. Back here in Toronto. Minute and a half into the third period. No score in the hockey game, and Manderville comes to center. He is checked from behind by Rutu. Eastwood carries on. Pearson in front of the net. Eastwood centered it. Down goes Belfour, made a fine stop off Todd Gill. Pearson is in. Eastwood is bowled over in the goal crease area. The Leafs are pressing here. Chicago finally get it out, and Rutu's across center to the Leaf line and in, and Gill got back. Gill turns, skates immediately to center ice. The Leafs were changing. Manderville was headed off, allowing the Blackhawks to clear the zone quickly. Isambard is moving up. Chance gets in front of the net. Isambard can't feed it to him, and the Maple Leafs clear the zone. Clark is on the ice. Gilmore and Gardner. Eisenhardt shoots it in. Dubinsky with him, so is Chance. He has the puck. Chance. Stopped by Gardner. Gardner pulled away from Dubinsky's check. A long leap past the Clark. Trying to leg it in there on Chelios. Clark stopped by Chelios. And it's the Blackhawks. Eisenhardt coming back in. He centered it. Eisenhardt and Dubinsky. Gilmore all the way back in his own zone, but here's Chelios. Shot right in front off the stick of Eisenhardt. And the Leafs get it up to Clark again. A little bit too far for him this time. He's in there trying to steal it from Suter. Suter, though, very clever, moved one way and gave it to Chelios, who was behind the net. 3 minutes gone in the third period. Two teams changing. Play flowing right along. Gilmore coming back. Can he beat Christian? He could not, so he just shot at the center. Bird couldn't pick it up. Amonte turned, rapped at it, and Christian knocked it into the Leaf zone. Lefebvre and Zezel. Zezel tipped it out to Osborne. To Zezel, but Christian saw that play develop. Made a good defensive move to get back. Chicago on it. Smith ahead to Amonte. Christian brings it in. That's offside. Amonte couldn't get back out that fast. And offside is called. Well, the other late games, our updates are started now with Around the Flame.
Bob, isn't it funny? We've played for a little over 2 hours. There's just been another goal at Calgary, but we'll show you this one first. Don Cherry mentioned he had respect for Pavel Bure, who had been pressing. He'll love this goal. Bure from Adams, pretty pass by Greg Adams and Trevor Linden. So Vancouver strikes at 4:48 to open the scoring there.
Daryl Sutter's made a lineup change here. He's got Murphy off the Roenick line and put him on left wing with Sutter and Graham, and put Dave Christian in his spot with Roenick and Amonte. Spread out the possible scoring.
Well, you can't blame the two coaches. They'll search for anything now. They played two periods and 4 minutes of another. No goals. Brett Sutter shoots it in. Hot fan played it on the boards. Green was there. Nearly caught him. Graham again stopping the pass. Chelios waited at the blue line. Graham coming for the net. The pass and a crowd. And Andrejczuk will start back with Borshevsky. Gilmore's catching up. Andrejczuk shooting it in back to the net. It comes off the boards in the corner. And it's played out to Chelios. Up to Brent Sutter at center. Dirk Graham comes over the line. Couldn't get in there. Good play by Gil. Andrejczuk now can't make the pass, but it's knocked down by Lefebvre. Borshevsky is pulled in across the line by Chelios, so he has to clear the zone. Chelios up with Rich Sutter, and he shoots it from the center ice. They just want to dump it in now. Somebody looking for the first break. There hasn't been one in the game yet. Rich Sutter is around the net trying to center it. He's Will Battler fighting hard on the boards, gets the puck loose and escapes. Trying to knock it back along the line. Didn't work. And the Leafs pick it up and get it out to center. Eastwood didn't see his winger Pearson behind everybody. They are circling back in the Chicago zone. Here's a steal by Pearson. Pearson in. Trying to center. Scramble for it. Eastwood back in the goal. Vanderbilt, a big pileup, and the three forwards are caught back there. But the Blackhawks do not get it out cleanly. Stopping the rush again. Allen fires it back in. Amonte took it on his skate. Left it for Weinrich. He can't find it. He's hit him there by Vanderbilt, who fell. The Blackhawks, Jeremy Roenick, speeding in. Roenick takes a look at Poffin, but he can't put the puck over there. Ellett stole it. Two leagues get it up to center. Here comes Zezel. He got up to the Chicago line. And the glove pass. The play called. 5:58 gone in the third period. We are scoreless.
One at Calgary.
Pat Burns has been able to get McCollum and Lefebvre against Roenick. 14 of the 20 shifts tonight. You can't do any better than that. That's counting penalties, changing on the fly, etc.
McCown takes the puck at center, wraps it into the boards in the corner. Gary Suter was slow moving over there. Osborne and Zezel were in to pick it up, back to the line. Here's a shot, deflected, and a penalty being called on the play. And it's going to be against Chicago. Or maybe, wait a minute now, Chicago had the puck when he stopped the play. So we'll wait and see. Could be the Leafs, they're the ones doing the arguing. And they get the penalty.
Goaltender interference on Osborne. Now, you have to know this. Balfour has been decked about four times this period. And maybe Koharski has seen enough. I think he made the right call there. No attempt. The rule of thumb is, does the offensive player attempt to avoid the goalie? I'm not sure Osborne did. Now, Balfour has been knocked flying three times before this in the period. Here's one of the three times. Goaltenders deserve more protection than they usually get. I know it's a tough call, but they should not be sitting ducks, especially when they're in the crease trying to stop the puck.
Well, it's a tough call now against Pat Burns and the Toronto Maple Leafs, that is for sure. Osborne is off for goaltender interference. We have played 6 minutes and 13 seconds of the third period. There is Osborne, and here comes the sixth power play of the game for the Chicago Blackhawks.
Well, Darryl Sutter knows his team has to jack it up a notch. They were outshot badly in the second period, 14-3. They were outchanced 10-1. Not one Hawk forward had a shot on goal. You can't dodge the bullet all night with those stats staring you in the face.
Well, Chicago has yet to get a shot in this second period. And over two periods now and a bit here in the third, it's 29-10 in favor of Toronto. But no score out there yet. Chicago down a power play. Roenick coming in with a Monty. Roenick pulls away from one check, gets it back to Chelios, and here's Suter. He rolled it in there. Shot was deflected wide of the goal. Chelios will do it again. Roll it for the net. Big rebound. And there's a Leafs. Game saver. Who thought he had one. Was sure he had one. But Puckman said, oh. And he whipped out the glove. And that's the best save of this hockey game.
That is the second shot on goal on five power play chances. But it is the best one. When he made that catch in the air, Bob, I'm sure the puck was on the goal line. And it is a superb stop. A lovely pass there by Roenick. Look where his hand is. Boy, he hasn't been busy, but he can't make him any better now.
He had just 11 stops before that sensational grab. To keep this at no goals. Minute 25 left of the Chicago power play. Chelios poked it ahead. Roenick back to Chelios. Again, Amonte on the outside. Leafs are set up pretty well with that box. Amonte running out of time. Back to Amonte again. Chelios decides to shoot it. It was batted out of the air with a high stick, and that will stop the play. And they bring it all the way back inside the Chicago blue line. Here he goes, the referee, Koharski. He says, down there, a high stick by the Chicago player. Why, you have the man advantage, and you'll see it here.
But look at the stop that Puckman makes on the deflection by Joe Murphy. And Murphy trying to bat it in from over the crossbar, which is the standard. It bounces off Puckman's mask and stays out. And you're right, Bob, a 200-foot penalty against the Hawks for touching the puck over the goal, the crossbar, on a power play.
103 left on that power play now. Osborne is the lead player in the penalty box. Toronto nothing, Chicago nothing. The series tied, two games apiece. It gets bigger and bigger as this third period moves along. who'll get the first one. The way these two teams have been playing, it might be the only one.
And it may not come in this period.
Face off to the right of Belfour. Zezel and Roenick square off. Roenick won the draw. Chelios takes his time, lugging it out to center. Put it in off the lead player, right to Potvin. He'll slow it down. 52 seconds left in Osborne's penalty.
I'd like to give a big hockey night in Canada. Get well hello to Lou Pasador, who's in the Hamilton General Hospital just getting over a heart bypass. He was a talented scout for Emil Lacat Francis when Emil was the GM for the Rangers, the Blues, and the Hartford Whalers. Get better quick, Lou. You found a lot of hockey players for the Cat.
52 seconds left in the penalty to the Leafs. Osborne, Chicago make a change. They leave Roenick on with Amonte and Murphy. Now they've switched back and got the big five on again. Suter and Chelios on the blue line. McCown and Lefebvre, the Leaf defenseman. It's going to be Lefebvre. And he'll send the Blackhawks back because he gives it to Vanderbilt. Shot, missed on the short side with a hard shot. There was some room there. Vanderbilt again. Here's Gilmore stealing the puck, spinning back with it. Gilmore lost it and three Hawks are on the attack.
So I don't know whether it was. Let's have a look. Behind the play, Gary Suter. The puck is squirted out of the zone. Away goes Gilmore, and away goes Suter. And Suter punches him. But Don Koharski watched the whole play as he was also behind the play and decided it was not a penalty. Here's another look. The puck's out of the zone. There's the punch, and you wonder if Gilmore twisted his right knee when he fell.
Well, here comes Koharski now. Right after Gilmore hit the ice, he pulled away. I thought he had gone. I knew Finn was back there. And Gilmore got back to his feet very slowly, and here he goes with Chris Broadhurst of the Leaf training staff, the right athletic therapist, into the room.
Well, on that replay, the last one, you can see Gilmore skate caught, and as he fell after being knocked down by Suter, he fell and kind of sat on his right ankle. You have to think that he may have hurt his right knee or his right ankle. Koharski was looking at it, didn't call it.
Leafs have already lost to Dmitry Mironov on a hit in the second period. And he has a bruised right thigh, we are told. We thought maybe it was a knee injury as he was helped off, but it has been confirmed, a bruised thigh. So he won't be back tonight. A very concerned management staff here at Maple Leaf Gardens. Cliff Fletcher, the president.
I tell you, Koharski is letting the Hawks change one guy at a time. They put six skaters out, see who the Leafs was out, and then they take one off.
Blackhawks power play, another 20 seconds. Zezel flicked it down the ice with his glove, but the play had been whistled dead, and another face-off in the lead zone. 17 seconds now left in Osborne's penalty. No score.
Well, Doug Gilmore, his resiliency is one of his great attributes, but physically, you can only do so much. So if you're a Leaf fan, you got to be holding your breath right now.
And what a game he has had tonight. The 8-minute mark of this third period. Long shot in, bounces low on the boards, hopped high, and goes to the far side. 5 seconds left in Osborne's penalty. Blackhawks. Coming up to center is Graham. The Leafs have killed off.
Determined forechecking, going to the net.
some guys.
800.
He fell forward. Been absolutely marvelous tonight. Had no chance on that. A great pass from Anderchuk after he took it from Clark to Eastwood, who had the presence of mind to go to the net with a stick on the ice. There was a puck. 1-0 Leafs. 9:20 to go in the third period.
That is his first goal of the playoff. 10:07 was the time of it. A huge goal by Mike Eastwood of the Maple Leafs. Toronto 1, Chicago nothing. Murphy's pass into Ronick. Trying to get the job done. Amadi's shot is blocked by McCown. And again, back of the net, Ronick. Kicked it to the corner. It is Lefebvre taking it away from the net and giving it to Bird. Osborne on the play. And here comes Osborne to pick it up as Bird shot it in. Stick before he could get a shot away. Ronick going back. Osborne knocked down. The play goes right on. And Murphy misses the pass. McCown dumped it in. 8:35 left. Here comes Burr, pounding the Blackhawk defenseman. But it's Carney who gets the pass away to Brent Sutter. Following the play was Christian. That is offside. Sutter gone in ahead of Christian. 8:25 left.
Well, I mentioned before the game to Ron McLean that Daryl Sutter has to get some other forward to score. Here are the goals scored by the Hawks in this series. Murphy, Amonte, and Roenick, the only forward. What a job, Zezel, Osborne, Bird, Lefebvre, and McCown have done on Roenick tonight. He and his line mates have had four combined shots on goal and obviously no goals.
The shots in the game are by Toronto 35, by Chicago 13. But after that show by the Canadians and Patrick Waugh last night, you don't have to look at shots anymore. Look up at the board, baby, and see who's leading. That's how you tell who wins. Right now, Toronto is just a goal up on Chicago. 1-0. Frame goes in with Christian. Christian gets the puck loose and back to the line. Suter dumped it ahead and bounced over Green's stick. Brett Sutter there. And went flying high and down to Sutter in the corner with Graham. Graham is being checked by Anderchuk, who took the swipe at it. Christian kept it in. Clark, who is in behind everybody. 7:30 remaining in the third period. 1-0 Toronto. Chelios missing that pass from Green. Belfour out of the net. Yet Chelios crossed up for a second. There's an interception that goes off the boards at the far side down to Rich Sutter. And Lefebvre had to carry the body in on the boards. Sutter shakes it off and gets loose and after the puck. Rich Sutter fighting off Lefebvre. Manderville took a swipe at it. The Leafs can't get it out. It rolled in front of McCown, threw it to center ice. Pearson went up after it. Rich Sutter turning back. Coming over the Leaf line with a shot high off the blocker of Putman. And the Leafs dump it to the line. And out. It'll be offside as Rutu goes in to touch it. 6 minutes and 41 seconds remaining in the third period. Toronto leads 1-0.
You're looking at one Canadian.
Well, the Hawks, a tough assignment, Bob, to create offense after you've gone 55 minutes without much. 7 scoring chances by me for the Hawks. The Leafs are over 20.
Only 14 shots in the game by Chicago. But they are still alive. Only one goal up on the board. That by Eastwood of the Maple Leafs on a Leaf power play here in the third period. At 10:07. Zezel covering up for Toronto and getting the puck down the ice. Belfour will have to play with Bird coming in. Belfour played it away. And Murphy at his own blue line. The pass to Ronick popped away from him. Zezel bats it back inside his own line for Todd Gill. Chicago changing. Gill comes up to the Chicago blue line and put on on the brakes and rolled it in. 5:50 remaining in the third period. Chicago can't get too far in that rush. Gardner, burst of speed, got in. But Clark was slow coming back out, and Gardner was really flying as he turned the corner over there.
That's it for Doug Gilmore. He tried two shifts and couldn't move the way he wanted and came off 15 seconds into that shift with Gardner and Clark. Gary Bettman, the commissioner of the National League, on his left, Brian Burke, the vice president. Two new guys on the NHL administrative block.
And they're seeing a dandy tonight. These two teams have been close from, as they say, the get-go at 5:35 left in the third period now. This one, game five, the series two apiece. Toronto 1-2 here, Chicago 2 at home. And now the Leafs are leading in this one. Chicago on the attack. Eisenbart in the corner, looks around. Everybody seems to be covered, so he hangs on to it. Now loses it. Ellen skates away and put the high one down the ice. I believe Sutter touched it. Chelios played at the center. Chance flipped it up over the line. And the Chelios coming back again for Eisenbart. Eisenbart, rifle one high. That'll whistle into the crowd. We have under 5 minutes remaining now. 4:54 remaining in the third.
They do this.
No.
4 minutes and 54 seconds remaining in the third period. Any were saying?
Well, the three stars are coming up. It's a crime tonight if the Leafs hang on to this. They can't give more than three. This has been a determined effort. They've outplayed the Hawks badly. They're not in the clear yet. The Hawks haven't done much offensively at all tonight.
4:45 remaining in the third. Chicago looking up at that clock, knowing they have lots of time. Only had the 14 shots, though, in the game. They got to do something now soon. Open up a bit and go after the tying goal. 1-0 Toronto. Here is Jeremy Roenick centering into Grabe. On the short side. That was an excellent setup by Jeremy Roenick, and Dirk Grabe has been going to the net all night. Had a great chance there to tie it.
Well, Sutter again taking a page out of Pat Burns' book, and he's got Roenick playing on two lines, as Gilmore did for a lot of tonight's game before he got hurt. Potvin makes the stop on a bit of a dangerous shot. It wasn't a hard one, but it was rolling around there. 2 feet and pay dirt if you're a Hawks fan.
4:21 remaining in the third. Mike Eastwood has the only goal of the game. A Leaf power play. 10:07 the time here in the third period. Clark and Andrzejczyk drew the assists on that goal. And there's the man who scored it. Mike Eastwood, his first of the playoffs. And now he has the chore of watching Jeremy Roenick. And he wins the faceoff cleanly. The Leafs get it ahead. Manderville slapped it on the boards, hit out. Eastwood is up for checking. Gary Suter and Chelios. Suter from Chelios skating out. Not much room to move. The Leafs checking well. Slapped away to center. Here comes Pearson. He got up as far as Chelios at the Chicago line. 3:55 remaining in the third. 1-0 Toronto. Roenick coming in with Dubinsky. His shot juggled. Big rebound. The Leafs cover up and get it out. Pearson skates to center. Keeps going with it. Then gets a hit from Dubinsky. 3:40 to play in the third. Here is Murphy. Good speed, Murphy in. On with the brakes. Put it back to the line. And it's Osborne who was there to cover his man and get the puck back out. 3:25 left. 1-0 Toronto. Game five. This is the big lead game for one of these teams tonight. Up comes Amani. He tried to fool Ellett. Nothing doing. Ellett stayed with him and took him to the ice. Osborne lifted the puck too high, and it got into the crowd, so the faceoff will be inside the Leaf line with 3 minutes and 5 seconds remaining in the third.
Well, I mentioned Lefebvre and McCowan have played almost every shift against Roenick. There are very few defensemen in this league that are better one-on-one than Lefebvre. And what a game Peter Zezel's played. He also and his line mates Bird and Osborne have played nearly all shifts against Roenick. And he's got a victory star, perhaps, over his left eye.
Faceoff deep in Toronto territory to the right of Potvin. Pat Burns looks calm enough. That's outside, I'm sure inside. The nerves are jumping. Here's a pass back to the line. It is a shot. Stopped by Potvin. The drive by Weinrich right on. Clark bumped by Weinrich. He couldn't go after the puck. 2:50 remaining in the third period. It is Dirk Green finding an open man at the far side who sliced it in. Rick Sutter chased it. And Gartner got back. Rouse took his man. Dirk Green in on the boards. Tries to hold him there. The puck is loose. And coming out again, it is Dave Ellen. He's been logging the puck a lot tonight for Toronto. Green poked it away to center. Here's Graham coming in. Graham turning back. Circles at the line. Chelios has bucked off the puck. 2:15 remaining in the third period. Otto leading 1-0 and hanging on here. Move down to Clark. He won't stride up there in time. Gary Suter to Roenick. Big guns on there now for Chicago. Shot in. Wide of the net. And Lefebvre was back quickly. And clears it back out. Minute 50 left of the third period. Up through center. Suter. He shoots it in. Hot pay out of the net. Going to Zezel. Zezel going to center ice. Berg going after the puck. He's up over the line against Chelios. Barely made in there. Big loose puck in front of the net. We welcome you people watching the Calgary-Vancouver game. I'm Bob Cole with Harry Neal in the booth at Maple Leaf Gardens, and the Leafs have scored here in the third period with a minute 20 left. The goal coming at 10:07. Mike Eastwood from Clark and Adamchuk. They lead Chicago 1-0. And the third period running out. It fired back in the net and cleared back to center ice. 1 minute left in the third period in game 5 of the series tied 2-2. Here's Eastwood coming in. Big rebound, Eastwood going after it, and it was Pearson who drove it. Vanderbilt on there also for Toronto. 45 seconds remaining. That has been a big checking line. The net empty for Vanderbilt. He hit the post. It hit the post. Vanderbilt trying to ice this one. 32 seconds remaining.
And Gilmore face to face all night. Eastwood scores, Potvin gets the shutout, but here are the Molson three stars. Peter Zezel, great defensively tonight. The big job for the Leafs was to contain the Roenick line at center. He did the job, and on defense, not enough can be said for Jamie McCowan, the number two star of this evening. And the number one star is the unheralded Sylvain Lefebvre. A lot of Leafs contributed to a 1-0 shutout victory. They lead the series 3-2 and have a 90% chance of advancing. However, more ahead. Tomorrow night from Montreal and then Thursday night from Chicago. Thanks for watching this evening from all of us. Good night.
Introducing the newest orange juice sensation from Tropicana. Tropicana Pure Premium Grove Stand. 100% pure, not from concentrate orange juice. Tropicana Pure Premium Grove Stand has a taste so fresh, so pure, so real. Every sip is like biting into an orange, right down to the peel. Pure Premium Grove Stand. The newest orange juice sensation from Tropicana.
The Nissan Maxima GXE comes equipped with a 3-liter V6 engine, a 100-watt Dolby stereo, alloy wheels, power seats, and a price tag $2,000 lower than Toyota Camry. In fact, if we...
...be available for Game 6 Thursday in Chicago. More on that in the post-game report. First, the visuals tonight from the Garden. Exciting it was, goaltending dominating the affair. Roenick dumps Gilmore behind the net, moves in front, but Felix stops him on the wraparound. 0-0, a familiar score all night long. At the other end, Gilmore will take a great pass from Todd Gill, sweep in front of Belfour, but at steady Eddie is there to reject him. Meanwhile, keeper Sutherland, among those at the Garden's wildly excited tonight, but true to craft, acting very cool. Second period, Dirk Graham with a big check on the knee of Dmitry Mironov. Down goes the tree. Mironov had to be helped from the ice, but no penalty was called. Later in the second, Belfour comes up big as he stops Wendell Clark. Wendell fires the wrist shot, rebound to Gartner, and Eddie stones him as well. During a power play, it'll be Gilmore with a perfect setup to Gartner. Still looking for that first goal of the series, and not gonna happen again. Belfour comes up large, 0-0 after two. Third period, save of the night though, as Felix Potvin will rob Joe Murphy. The glove almost inside the post, but not quite, as Felix comes up with a nifty glove save. A little later on, it'll be Gary Suter, the hero on Sunday night, dumping Doug Gilmore along the boards. Gilmore has his leg cut behind the play. Koharski rules no call, even though he was right on top of it, and with Gilmore lying prone on the ice. It's time to move to the door. Pat Burns, may I have a word with you, sir, please? Voices his disapproval as Gilmore hobbles off the ice, returned, took another shift, and then skated off after about 15 seconds. Later in the third, Leafs break the scoreless tie on the power play as Mike Eastwood chips in the pass from Dave Andrechuk, and that was it. No more scoring. Leafs hang on to win it 1-0. Back-to-back 1-0 shutouts for Felix in Toronto. His goals against average here is .33. Chicago, another story. Felix Potvin, 17 saves, as mentioned, his second shutout of the series, as the Leafs lead it 3-2. And now, standing by live and in concert, Mark Hebscher at Maple Leaf Garden. Hebs.
Yes, Don. Well, you know, I think Felix should have gotten a star as well tonight, but I'm not the one who picks them on those national telecasts, but I'm with you. He played a heck of a game. We're going to hear from him in just a second. This is like two different series. The game's in Chicago, high scoring, all over the place, puck bouncing around like at a pinball arcade. And here, defensive stalwarts, the Leafs are. Felix Potvin has allowed one goal in 3 games at the Gardens for goals against average of .33, if my calculations are correct. The Leafs win, but at what cost? We'll talk about that. Pat Burns was asked earlier what he thought of his team's defensive play tonight.
Well, it was a lot similar to the game we played, nothing here. It was similar, but we had a lot of, we outchanced them in the scoring chances quite a bit, but you know, you got to give a lot of credit to Eddie Belfour. I think it was a fantastic game by Eddie, probably the best I've ever seen him play, and we finally got one in behind him, and Felix stopped the big ones when it was time.
How's Gilmore?
He's fine. It's a muscle strain more than anything else. He was going to come back. I told him just to go get it ice, and if we go into overtime, well, I said, you'll come back out. So he'll spend some time on ice tonight, but he should be all right.
So we played a really good game tonight. I think we really bounced back, and we were ready for that game, and I didn't have to face that many shots.
Were you worried about that, the fact that they only had 10 shots?
Well, it was a tough mentally game for me. Eddie was playing very well at the other side, and going into the third, I knew they would have at least one good chance, and I mean, I just tried to stay focused on every shot, and I mean, again, we had a great third period.
The save on Murphy, tell us about that.
Well, I saw him having the puck in right in the the hash mark there, and I tried to get over, and I just got a glove on.
Tonight, how tough was he?
He's unbelievable. As you guys can imagine, you saw him. He made big save after big save, and he's been doing it all series. No surprise he's doing it again tonight, and it's going to be tough again in game six.
When was the last time you saw that much ice time, Peter?
Probably last time in the playoffs against the top lines. We, Bergie and Ozzie and myself certainly talk about what we have to do against those guys, and we have to shut them down. We're not going to outscore that line, but at least we can keep them off the board, and we get our job done.
Great job by the checking line, as you well know, but also, too, Mike Eastwood playing on a line with Kent Manderville and young Rob Pearson. Eastwood with the only goal, a fifth-round pick, 91st overall in 1987, just coming into his own. I think last year at this time, a lot of folks thought that maybe Eastwood wasn't, you know, going to be a regular on this team. Well, he certainly has proved himself. The Hawks obviously down after losing again and not scoring again here at the Gardens. Some comments now from the Blackhawk locker room.
What about Elkford's performance?
He was outstanding. I mean, I think that was obvious. And you can say what you want. The other guy only had 17 shots, but the save of the night was on Joe Murphy.
Think it was in?
I thought it was. It was pretty close to the line. I mean, I think his glove was right on the line, but he was quick and snapped it right out of the air. And it's too bad. I mean, would have been a big goal for us. Probably would have won the game.
Yeah, they were going hard to the net and bumping me and interfering. And, you know, I have to thank Don Gaharski and the linesman for doing a great job and, calling a few penalties there. And, you know, I want to thank them for doing a good job for me there tonight.
Eddie, Pat Burns said that's the best game he's ever seen you play. It's a pretty high compliment. Is that one of the best of your career with this team?
Well, it's definitely a compliment. I feel like, I have to play better and we have to play better as a team.
Maybe we should take a page out of their book and go to their net harder and create more, havoc in front of their net.
Like I said, Don, without the Blackhawk crowd at the stadium and without the last line change, Chicago's a totally different team. Bernsey just sent out Berg, Osborne, Zezel and really shut the number one line down. And except for Dirk Graham, who has one assist, no other Hawk forward except for Amande Murphy and Roenick has done anything.
Yeah, no question, last change made a big difference tonight, but there was a moment in the first period, loose puck outside the Hawk blue line, Todd Gill has a chance to go for it or drop back, and there was no decision to be made. He dropped back tonight, and I think that's the key. The question now is, can they get that kind of protection for Felix in Chicago?
Yeah, and also, too, in Chicago, because the neutral zone is 15 feet less. I'll be all right. It's been a long night. The 15 feet less is all in the neutral zone, so a lot of times when the Leaf defensemen have the puck, they think they have an extra half second when they really don't in Chicago, and the forecheckers are right on top of them. And
former Islander star Mike Bossy entertaining the Forum fans tonight, although the guy looks like he's listening to the Hips. Second period, Boston goes up by two, shot by Bork, partially blocked. Cam Stewart slides it over. Steve Hines bats it out of midair. No chance for Patrick on that one. It's 2-0 Boston. Habs do get that one back late in the second on the power play. John LeClaire with a wraparound, and it's 2-1 after two before the net is dislodged, by the way. Habs tied early in the third. Great play by Kirk Muller right from the faceoff. Unassisted marker, it's 2-2. A little later on, Iafredi responds with an unassisted effort of his own. As the puck pops loose, Iafredi moves in, snaps the wrister through the pads of Patrick Roy, and suddenly it's a series again. They're going back to Boston for Game 7 on Friday night. Ray Bourque had a pair of helpers tonight. Boston goals from Smolinski, his second, Hines, his first, and hard to believe, that was Al Iafredi's first of the postseason. John LeClaire had his second for Montreal. Kirk Muller rewarding those pool selectors in a big way with his sixth in the series.
For the second time in this year's playoffs, two teams have failed to score in regulation time. Now, when the Hawks and the Leafs did it was only the second game of the series. But Buffalo was in a winner-get-out situation at the odd tonight against the Devils. We're still waiting for that one, folks. First period, no score. Randy Moeller with a shot from the point goes through Brodeur, but off the post. And we have no score after one period. The second, the Sabres look to have one right here. However, immediately, the referee, Terry Gregson, will wave it off. And we will go to the replay and show you exactly why Jason Daw running into Martin Brodeur on the replay. And John Muckler says, what are you talking about? That counts. There's nothing wrong with that at all. Later in the second, another Sabres goal is called back.
No.
Wayne Pressly kicks it in right there. A good call. Now, I'll bet you Muckler's really impressed about this. Let's check John on the Sabres bench. Yay! in? No, sir, not at all. What are you talking about? That one wasn't in. It's a conspiracy. Third period, Devils almost get the score. Big save there. Hasek with the stop on Stefan Ariche. Folks, we have played 80 minutes. Yes, we're in the first overtime intermission. No score. Buffalo has to win to force the seventh game in the Meadowlands. Now we'll get back to hockey right over here. Right, there we are. We'll get back to hockey in just a moment, but of all teams to come up with a no-hitter, the Minnesota Twins would be about the last one you'd select.
Against the Hawks, the big question, how is Dougie Gilmore? Problem is, the only guy who really knows the answer wasn't around to be asked. More from Sportsline's Mark Hebscher.
The Leafs had a light workout today prior to boarding a plane to Chicago. Conspicuous by his absence was Doug Gilmore, who fell awkwardly in the third period of last night's game and had to be helped off the ice, suffering from an ankle injury, the extent of which is not known. One thing is for certain, Gilmore and Gilmore alone will decide whether he'll play tomorrow.
The doctors definitely haven't nothing to say about it anymore now. I mean, say it's all up to how Doug's going to feel tomorrow morning at the morning skate.
Sorry, what's he feeling right now? I couldn't get to the mic in here.
Probably pain. Yeah. A little bit of pain. And he's got it on ice, but that's playoffs. You got to play with a bit of pain. He knows that. And it's not as bad as it looked, I guess, on TV last night. I mean, say he came back and tried it a couple of times, and he couldn't go. I said, just go in and ice it now. And if we go into overtime, come back. And if we don't, well, stay on the ice. So he stayed on ice, and this morning he still has his ankle in ice.
The Leafs' other injury last night occurred midway through the second period when Dmitry Mironov was kneed by Hawks captain Dirk Graham. This is nothing new for Graham, who twice before has gone after Mike Gartner in the same fashion. Mironov was having trouble turning today and feels Graham's hit deserved a penalty.
Yeah, I watched in the replay in Sportsline 11:30, and I think it's a bad play, the cheap shot. And I don't know what's happening in Kaharski, not calling. And before, a couple times, and Mike Gartner, Mike Gartner.
Yeah, so Graham is, trying to take you guys out?
Yeah, why not? I think so.
How does it feel today?
I'm a little sore and a turn in the right, but see you tomorrow morning, I think. If I feel better, I play.
Leaf captain Wendell Clark has been rather quiet the last two games as well.
Okay, Wendell, we've been watching the last couple games. You haven't been banging as much as usual. Are you hurt at all?
No, everything's fine. It's, like I say, it's really close checking, and we play a couple back-to-back games that are going to fatigue the bodies a little bit. So I don't think I've been going out of the way to over-fatigue myself in ways, too. So it's just, it's been very, very tight checking.
So the Leafs hobble into Chicago for Game 6 tomorrow night at the stadium. It could be the final hockey game at that grand old arena. Doug Gilmore and Dmitry Mironov, not so much day-to-day, rather hour-to-hour. And we'll be there tomorrow at practice at the stadium to give you an update on their progress and whether they'll play or not. Until then, this is Mark Hebscher with the Maple Leafs in the Stanley Cup playoffs for Sportsline.
Of course, the stadium itself is the Hawks' main hope. Coach Daryl Sutter says the matter will strictly be in the hands of the fans.
I was thinking last night coming home in the plane, the key tomorrow night is going to be the support of our crowd. Our guys are going to be energized, I know how much of a lift it was for our team in games 3 and 4 to come home to that.
All right, in one of the other series, about the only positive note for the Red Wings is that the balance of their playoff with San Jose will take place at the Joe Louis Arena. Chris Osgood, who was yanked early in last night's loss on the coast, will be back in the nets for Game 6 as the Wings face a win-or-else situation.
In the last few years here, this team has been up a lot of times against adversity, sometimes came through it, and a lot of times haven't, and now it's time to see what we're made of.
Chris, at this point in the series, we would have liked to have played the fifth game at home, but hey, sometimes you lose the fifth game at home, and then you got to go and play in their den, so the way it's working now, we're comfortable to come home and play the next game.
We're not worried. I mean, we're in a tough situation. I don't think anybody expected us to be down 3-2. We expected it to be a tough series, but for the most part, we've doing some good things. Well, we battled back. Unfortunately, we gave them, you know, a couple two-goal leads last night. But the positive thing is we're playing at home, and we got both games are going to be here.
Well, they're hooping it up in the Rockies tonight. Vancouver has become the second Canadian city this year to be awarded an NBA franchise. They'll start play along with Toronto for the 95 season. More from Don.